Bears hockey, part of the Triple Cities Family Dental pregame show. Brooks Hill, soon to be joined by my partner Alex Jones here on the pregame show. The Black Bears trying to win a second consecutive game, and Danbury trying to avoid their first three-game losing skid of the season tonight. It's the heavyweight battle scheduled for three rounds of 20 minutes each tonight inside the 607 area code here in central New York, and you're listening to the Triple Cities Family Dental pregame show. Triple Cities Family Dental makes your smile a priority. Schedule an appointment today by calling them at 607-545-4148 today. Time to go ahead and take a look back to last weekend in the Black Bears, part of Black Bears Rewind. The Black Bears were up in Michigan, Port Huron, Michigan, to be exact, and the Black Bears would end up splitting the season series and the weekend with a 3-2 victory, thanks to Austin Thompson scoring a power play goal with 70 seconds left to go in regulation time. So I welcome in my partner Alex Jones. Alex, the Black Bears team, coaching staff, and support staff really going through the ringer last week in Michigan, but very happy and pleased to skate away with 3 points thanks to Austin Thompson late in the contest.
Yeah, Brooks, an excellent goal from that top line that's doing so well of Lopez, Ivashkin, and Thompson. Thompson, 1 minute, 10 seconds left, puts it in the back of the net to give the Black Bears a 3-2 lead and be able to split those victories, which is huge after the first night dropping a hard one.
Yeah, the Black Bears lost 6-3 on Friday night, but they would turn it around and win 3-2 in regulation time. That is Black Bears Rewind, presented by the Binghamton Hockey Booster Club. You can join the Booster Club by visiting them, the table behind every game for the Black Bears in Section 4. It's only $10 to join the Booster Club, and they have exclusive player events, they have monthly meetings, and a whole lot more. So go ahead and join the Binghamton Hockey Booster Club next time you make your way over towards Binghamton. We're going to take a timeout, come back with the Tully's Coach's Corner and my very special interview with interim head coach Brant Sherwood after these messages on Fox Sports 1430 in Binghamton.
If you missed today's career fair and are still seeking a job, check out the businesses that are still on the concourse. We have a hockey field weekend coming up next week against the Red Hawk Carolina Thunderbirds. Friday night, the Black Bears will celebrate the great state of Pennsylvania with PA Appreciation Night. And on Saturday, it'll be Teacher Appreciation Night. And on Sunday, the final game of the weekend, the Black Bears will celebrate Kids Day with a very special 3 p.m. puck drop. Head on over to BinghamtonBlackBears.com or call the office at 607-722-7367 and reserve your seats now for a great weekend of Black Bears hockey.
The officials for tonight's game have been signed by the MPHLR: Joe Testa, Bill Bard, Isaac Kessler. 13, Donald Olivieri. Number 22, Tyler Jurich. Number 57, Cameron Yarwood.
Right now, I think it's the biggest game in Binghamton.
The scratches for the Danbury Hat-Tricks tonight. Number 9, Gordy Bunnell. Number 17, Riley Robertson. Number 19, Johnny Ruiz. Number 22, Dustin Gesso. The starting lineup tonight for the Danbury Hat-Tricks. At forward, number 44, Jacob Ratliff. On defense, number 6, Xavier Abdella. On defense, number 7, Kyle Gonzalez. At forward, number 15, Evan Lugo. At forward, number 14, Daniel Ansbury. And starting goal for Danbury tonight, number 30, Brian Wilson.
Style of play, but right now it's all mental, and whoever gets more chances on the power play most likely has a better chance to win. So if we can stay out of penalty trouble, then we should be good to go.
All right, Coach Sherwood, thank you for your time. We definitely appreciate it.
Thank you so much, Brooksy. Always a pleasure.
That is the voice of interim head coach Brant Sherwood. More to come on the Triple Cities Family Dental pregame show after these messages on Fox Sports 1430 in Binghamton.
Triple Cities Family Dental pregame show, Brooks Hill and Alex Jones. Along with the ride here, Cole Parenti will be our ringside reporter for tonight's contest as well. Now time to go ahead and get into the injuries and scratches for tonight's game, brought to you by our friends over at the Court Gesture Athletic Club. And Alex, tonight, Black Bears are going to be without Tyler Jurich and Cam Yarwood still out of the lineup, and Riley McVay, Don Oliveri, the healthy extras in the lineup for the Black Bears.
Yeah, and Brooks, you know, giving McVay a couple nights off, he's had so much of the workload throughout the season. It makes sense as we get down that stretch, you want him to be healthy come playoff time. Give him a couple extra rest nights there to just rest his body, make sure it's right for the playoffs is a smart decision by Coach Brian Sherwood.
Those are the injuries and scratches tonight. Also worth mentioning, Jake Schultz's suspension had been reduced now to 3 games instead of 5. So he will be out this weekend. He is unavailable for the Black Bears as well. So those are the court gesture, athletic club injuries, and scratches tonight. And before we get ready to wrap it up here, we'll go ahead and talk to you about tonight's Thompson & Johnson goaltending matchup, the Thompson & Johnson Equipment Company elevating your expectations. And for the Danbury Hattricks, it'll be number 30, Brian Wilson, coming in with a record of 18-4-5 on the season, a save percentage of .913, and a goals against average of .281. Facing off with the Black Bears, Taylor Joseph, 2-0 on the year, .941 save percentage, and 2 goals against in both games so far in this contest.
Yeah, and Brooks, is going to be the biggest tale of the tape between these two teams. Whichever goalie comes out hot is going to be the one that leads his team to victory. Joseph, 2-0, great pickup by the Black Bears. Looks like a great piece to add to your goalie rotation. Really excited to see him in this game.
That's the Thompson & Johnson goaltending matchup brought to you by the Thompson & Johnson Equipment Company, elevating your expectations. And let's go ahead and move into the American Standard Heating and Air Conditioning starting lineups tonight for the Binghamton Black Bears. It's going to be the second line, Gavin Yates in the center, with the SUNY Oswego Lakers, Mac Lewis and Tyson Kirkby on the wings. And on the defensive blue line, it'll be Justin Coachman, the veteran, and the young gun, Colin Fitzgerald, manning the blue line for the Black Bears.
Yeah, Brooks, and I love the pairing of Coachman and Fitzgerald. You get Fitzgerald, who can jump in on the rush, really get after the puck, and a great speed guy on the rush to get around some bigger defenders. And then you have a defensive defenseman specialist, one of the elite defensive defensemen in this league, Justin Coachman, who can just lock down the best player on the opposing team. It's going to be really fun to see them on this first shift. They work well, so well together. That juxtaposition between the two is always a good chemistry mix.
Well, and that is the American Standard Heating and Air Conditioning starting lineup tonight. We got also a couple of youth starters making their way out onto the ice as well. Tonight is Asha Knight, American Special Hockey Association, playing a tournament here in the area. A lot of kids participating in special hockey from all regions of the country making their way over here tonight. So just an absolutely great opportunity for some kids in youth hockey to make their way with their families out to the arena. And a lot of fans, I believe, are still taking part in the concession lines, Alex, for a 2-for-1 beers once again on Friday night.
Yeah, and Brooks, one of the things to notice as well, talking about starting lineups, starting for the Danbury Hattricks is Daniel Amesbury, one of the most prolific fighters in this league. It'll be interesting to see if it drops the glove right off the bat.
All right, we will step aside. The presentation of the anthem is coming up right after these messages on Fox Sports 1430 on Binghamton. That was the voice of Cander High School performing God Bless America tonight. The Binghamton Civil Air Patrol also operating as the color guard tonight.
From East Middle School, 13-year-old Civil Air Patrol Cadet Staff Sergeant Jaden Badger.
And Jaden Badger, tonight's solo is for the Star Spangled Banner. I think just knocked that right out of the park.
I'll tell you what, Brooks, I think those two groups give any of the groups so far we've had this year run for a money for their performances. Just awe-inspiring performances. But Brooks, I have a little bit of news to break on the broadcast as we sit here live. We officially have a sellout, mean every single ticket, including our standing room onlys, are sold out for tonight. It is absolutely insane, Brooks.
Well, it's a heavyweight bout, Alex, between the two sides, as there's also a ceremonial puck drop to go with it as well. 4,800 paid to see tonight's contest, and then pretty soon we're going to get ready for the heavyweight battle between the first and second place team all year long in the Empire Division.
It's going to be interesting, Brooks. You got Coachman and Amesbury out there first shift. You can feel there's energy in the air. The electricity is crackling in Visions Veterans Memorial Arena, and it is going to be, as you said, a heavyweight bout. Let's see if we get a heavyweight bout right off the drop.
Well, let's see how it all goes.
As I say that, Brooks, they're standing right now chatting with each other.
Amesbury and Kirkby already poking at each other, and Justin Coachman, Daniel Amesbury, ready to go.
Yep.
And Amesbury maybe just getting the start and try to shake his gloves off, trying to see which team was going to bite first. Nobody wanted anything to do with each other. Black Bears content to just start to play hockey as Danbury controls the opening faceoff tonight. Kyle Gonzalez ups the puck over to Evan Lugo, and there's the first save of the game made by Taylor Joseph on the wrist shot.
Well, and a smart move by the Black Bears. Justin Coachman making a really smart decision. The reason why is you are letting them take one of your defensive best defenders off the ice, and Amesbury is a more of a physical protector who doesn't really offer much in the pure skill set.
Gavin Yates drops it back for Fitzgerald. It hopped off his stick, but a little bit of a fumble put on by John McDonald. Puts the puck right back up to Mac Lewis and knuckle pucks it into the corner. It looks like that's going to steer aside for the hat tricks, and they might get out of Dodge. Here comes Joseph DeBennett. A little bit of a tongue twide right there. DeBennett, one of the new acquirees for this squad. Hasn't played too many games, but getting his first look at the Black Bears this season.
Yeah, and Brooks, we got an offside here. Danbury did not leave the zone fast enough for the linesman liking. Danbury wins the draw, draws it back, a pass across the ice. Nikita Ivashkin harasses him as the Danbury player drops it in deep.
Oh boy, Lahr tries to put on a tight turn, left the puck back behind the net, but luckily Chad Lopez comes out. He's going to try to clear it, but it's a turnover shot from Marchessault is knocked out of air after the save made by Joseph. Into the slot, redirected out in front, and Joseph makes another save. Black Bears try to get it out of their zone. Thompson now. First try, didn't get it out, but skates away on the second opportunity. Shot wide of the target. Ivashkin chasing after the rebound. Ivashkin dancing around the slot. Tried to get it to his forehand. Shot deflected. Knocked down. Out in front. Referee says to play on. That was pawed down by Chad Lopez. Puck still down. Looks like DeBennett lost his foot on the way through. And that puck's going to deflect off of a Danbury stick, I think, on the bench, and it should be an offensive zone faceoff coming up for the Black Bears.
Yeah, Brooks caught a Danbury stick right at the end of the bench, an unlucky one for Danbury. If, you know, it's probably going back anyway since that one's headed out of the play, but it looked like it was going to skirt right down the boards. Black Bears got a draw in their own zone, 17:59 left in the first, and Black Bears win, shot on net by Brett Parker.
Yeah, that was a quick turnaround shot. Parker and D'Angelo cause a four-man pileup, but former Black Bear Igor Borshishev gets the puck over. Newberg and Parker getting on the forecheck. Newberg throws a shot on goal while it looked like a member of the Hat-Tricks, or no, I believe it was Brett Parker lost his stick, so he just throws it to the net and forces the goalie to cover up.
D'Angelo did there, Brooks. He got caught by a hip check by Michael Falangia on Danbury.
Josh Newberg facing off with Borshishev. Borshishev, 6 points on the year since joining the Hat-Tricks, and now back from loan, Xavier Abduella wearing number 6 tonight in white. Danbury in the white tops, black breeches, and white socks, black helmets. Black Bears in the all-black attire. Stretch pass from Kyle Powell is unattainable, and now Borshishev will dump it in on goal, and Joseph will steer that one aside into the corner. Kyle Powell matched up tonight with Taylor Cutting on the blue line. Now D'Angelo gets the puck deep enough, calls for a line change, and Black Bears will get 5 new bodies out on the ice.
And so far, the Black Bears look very crisp in their zone entrances and exits.
A one hopper steered aside by the Black Bears goaltender. This puck's played off the glass, starts to roll on goal, and Wilson's forced to play it, nullifying the icing that could have been. Pamela on stretch pass, too far out of the reach of everybody, and this is icing coming up. And 16:48 left to go here. Shots 5 for Danbury so far and 2 for Binghamton.
Yeah, and those opportunities, Brooks, haven't been the most threatening ones. There was one very early they got on net, but wide shots. It's going to be interesting to see how this goes forward. This has the feel, like you said, of a heavyweight fight. A very, very aggressive contest as the Black Bears win the draw.
Goldschmidt throws a wrist shot, hits a hat-trick defender out in front. Yates gets to a loose rebound, tries to wrap it around. It's going to be stopped, but a penalty's coming up. Out in front, and slashing is going to be the call. And it looks like the Black Bears are going to be guilty of the first penalty tonight. An offensive zone penalty by Tyson Kirkby. That's one of your key penalty killers, and Danbury will have the first power play tonight.
And Brooks, not a penalty you need to take there. You had the puck in the offensive zone. You were starting your cycle. Catch a guy like that on the stick, and you see that stick pop up in the air. They're going to call that 10 times out of 10 as the Black Bears fight for the draw in their defensive zone. Coachman on the puck. Gets on its edge, stick into the feet of Colin Fitzgerald. No call from the official. Definitely looks like a trip, Brooks.
Yeah, the crowd wanted one right there, Alex, but unfortunately they're not going to get one. Jared Yao collects the loose puck behind his own net, and there's the first look at the new acquiree, Jacob Ratcliffe, all the way from New Zealand, Alex. So Danbury going worldwide on the roster now. Absolutely tore it up over in New Zealand, and now getting his first licks here tonight as a Danbury hat trick.
I don't know how many Kiwis there are in the Federal Prospect Hockey League, Brooks. It's something to look into.
You know, he might be the only person hailing from the Oceania side of the world. try to find out some more information on Radcliffe. That was a new acquiree today. Wilson left it behind, and Brett Parker gets on the forecheck to lay on a hit. We'll see if there's any other members of Oceania Nations playing with a FPHL team. Newberg and Ogic collide at center ice, and Newberg will be able to push the puck all the way back into the Danbury side. Mac Lewis trying to come away with a takeaway, but it finds the stick of double M Michael Marchessault, and Marchessault impeded by JT Walters drops it back over for Gonzalez. Danbury's power play has not been the best this year. Second from the bottom in the FPHL. Mac Lewis tries to fly the puck out of the zone, but a good keep by Gonzalez. Turnaround shot from a tip from Marchesan right on target. Joseph makes the save. Second opportunity blocked by Walters out in front, and the Black Bears defense clears it down 200 feet. 35 seconds left to go in the Northeastern Striping Corporation penalty kill. Black Bears operating just around 84%. That's just above the middle way point of the pack, Alex. And now Black Bears with some puck time. Stretch pass a little bit too far in front of Lopez, but it will force Brian Wilson to come out of his net to play the puck into the corner. 15 seconds left to go here in the power play opportunity. 3-on-2. Danbury crosses the line. They try to drop it back. Ivashkin had it hop over stick. Puck still available. 5 seconds for Ivashkin. Connects tape to tape with Lopez, and Lopez goes 1-on-1. Lopez, toe drag, power move out in front. Wilson makes the save. Penalty time is up, and Tyson Kirkby has rejoined the Black Bears. Danbury's power play goes 0-for-1 on the night. And turnover. Kirkby has it on his backhand. Tries to slap at it. Michael Falanga, who's really been heating up as of lately for the hat trick. Since the last time these teams have played, Falanga has 4 goals. Now up to 8 on the season. Black Bears try to come away with the takeaway, but it hops over into the palm of Jared Yao. They play it out into the neutral zone. Danbury crosses the line on sides, but stolen right away by Kyle Powell. Kirkby takes a peek behind him down the right wing side. Saucer pass, cross ice over to Gavin H. Low angle shot. Wilson made the save in and out of the glove. Puck still available. Yates taken down. Cutting, holding the line. Temporarily gets it right back to Yates. Amesbury back out on the ice. Takes a shove from Cutting. And now Evan Lugo goes 1-on-2. Tries to drag around. Blockered away by Joseph into the open corner. Taylor Cutting takes a peek, steers it back, brushes off a hit from Amesbury. Stretch pass off the stick of Abduella. Great stick by the newcomer, or I should say new returnee from Derry Perry. Pucker through the blue paint and out. Wilson a little indecisive, but just decides to paddle it away. Walters fumbled with it at the blue line, and now Newberg, who was covering, comes back out. Joseph coming out of his net to play the puck. Excellent job by the former AHL goaltender, Taylor Joseph. 13 minutes left here in period number one. Shots Danbury for 7. 4 for Binghamton. Boy, Lahr had his pass blocked by Marchessault, but lost a stick in the process. D'Angelo impeded at the blue line by DeBennett. Go ahead, Alex.
Not too happy about it, Brooks. He looked like he wanted a call there.
Yeah, DeBennett drops it back for Marchessault. Marchessault wide of the target. Don't know if Joseph saw that one around the screen. Pamela on cross ice for McDonald. Shot blocked by D'Angelo. Held in. Tipped on. Joseph makes the save at the top of the crease. And the Black Bears clear the zone. Danbury crosses the line off sides on the re-entry. And that finally sends us to our first media timeout of the night. 0-0, still searching for the first goal here in this one. A sellout crowd making its way back in from the concession stand here in Binghamton on Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton.
Special Hockey Association. For up to 520 saves at home this season, thank you to Visions Federal Credit Union for your support of the Black Bears and American Special Hockey Association. And now on the ice, let's welcome the Worldwide Sports Supply Ice Crew. Happy Friday, everybody. Ben from here with the Price Chop with Lucky Seed hanging out in section 24 tonight. Coming up here to the Guinea Corner. Hey, how you guys doing tonight?
Good.
You having a good time so far?
Yes.
Nice seats. You want better ones? Why not, right? Well, you'll get better ones when you come back next week on Friday's game when your Black Bears play the Carolina Thunderbirds. Right front row center. Let's hear for them.
twice, and now puts on a shot and swallowed up by Taylor Joseph.
Yeah, and Brooks, so far the goaltenders for both teams have been excellent. Brian Wilson, Taylor Joseph just putting on a clinic in goaltending through the first period. Total of 13 shots on the board. Feels like so much more.
No, Joseph got a couple inches on McVay and Forget, the other two Black Bears goaltenders. So also, I've noticed Joseph does have bigger pads as well. That might just come with the bigger stature. But now Fitzgerald crossing over the line, leaves it for Thompson. Backhander for Fitzgerald, saved by Wilson. Puck available in the blue paint. Nobody home for Binghamton, and Dan Barry escapes. 3-on-2 going the other way. Here comes Ogic. Ogic skating across, one-timer, save made by Joseph. Ratcliffe getting to a loose puck. He's marked by Colin Fitzgerald. Those two will tie up. And now Gonzalez pinching in from the blue line. Takes a good wrap check from Powell, separating the hat trick from the puck. And now Lopez skating through neutral ice. Tries to get it down to the right wing side. Ivoshkin tried a one-touch pass to himself off the boards. First try is unsuccessful. Now Ivoshkin gets it down low. Power move.
Oh.
Pulled off his stick at the last second. Lost his stick in the process as well. Held in by Cutting temporarily at the line. Thompson, wrist shot, blocked by Gonzalez, never made it towards the net. Ratcliffe takes a look over at the bench, got some tired Danbury bodies, and Ratcliffe tired, fanned on the puck on the initial try, sent down to the ice by Thompson right in front of the Black Bears bench. That'll give the crowd something to cheer about here. Now Gavin Yates through the middle of the ice, nifty move by Gavin, still with it, out in front, rolled his stick at the last second. Gavin Yates undressed the Danbury defense but could not make the finishing play. Chipped in, though, by Walters at the blue line. Black Bears trying to stay on the forecheck. Gavin Yates takes a high stick. Penalties coming up against Danbury. The trail referee saw it, and looks like Black Bears will have an opportunity now on the brand-new Henny Hard Seltzer power play.
Yeah, Brooks, it's unfortunate for Danbury that they just catch a stick, catches up Yates up high. The referees immediately are looking for injury, blood, anything like that. It'll be interesting to see what we get here on the Henny Hard Seltzer, whether it's a minor or a double minor.
They got 2 minutes up on the board, so a minor penalty. The brand new Henny Hard Seltzer power play.
Tell you what, Brooks, after this game, I'm going to enjoy myself a Henny Hard Seltzer or two.
Yeah, and just a unfortunate situation for Michael Marchessault there, just trying to play the puck, and sometimes the stick comes off. Black Bears with control. Ivoshkin in the slot. She puts it wide after they stole the puck away. Danbury won the initial faceoff. Lopez trying to move to the front, runs into the side of the net, running out of real estate. Two defensemen out on this unit for the Black Bears, Powell and Boylar, along with Ivoshkin, Lopez, and Thompson. Ivoshkin double-teamed, loses control of the puck, and Borshishev slaps it all the way down the length of the ice. Taylor Joseph plays the puck right back up to Austin Thompson. Black Bears are on size, trying to catch Danbury in a line change. Ivoshkin on his backhand. Puts it back over for Kyle Powell. Powell, slap pass, looking for a tip from Lopez out in front. Got one from Danbury instead. Powell holds the line. McKittrick loses his edge, tried to glide the puck. And now DeBennett tries to go 1-on-2. DeBennett taken down legally right in front of the official, says the play on. And now Colin Fitzgerald with a load of steam starts to come the other way. Drops it back for Yates. Line change for the Black Bears. Yates out in front for Ivoshkin. Save made by Wilson. Didn't know where the rebound was. One of the best chances of the night for the Black Bears so far. Fitzgerald back up at the blue line. 45 seconds left to go in the Henny Hard Seltzer power play. Ivoshkin down low. Tries to center up. In over in for Fitzgerald at the top of the umbrella. Trading places with Tyson Kirkby. Kirby looking for a shot, tipped wide by Thompson. The lone defenseman out on this unit, Fitzgerald, gets it back. One-timer for Yates, he scores! What a pass by Tyson Kirkby. The Black Bears power plays 1-for-1, and Binghamton has the early lead here in this one.
What an excellent job by the second power play unit out there. Kirkby and Yates, who have been together all year on the power play outside of Yates' injury, working together well, playing a little pitch and catch across the ice. Berkby gets it on Yates' six, and Yates laser beams it into the back of the net. 1-0 Black Bears.
8:40 left to go here in this one. Black Bears 1-for-1 on the brand new Henny Hard Seltzer Power Play.
It looks like we got a little bit of a false start, Brooks, on the draw after that goal. Everybody a little bit excited after that one.
Yates' 11th goal of the season. Alex Tyson Kirkby picks up his 45th point of the year, assist number 23 on the season. Puck is going to be dumped in. And Newberg plays the puck through the middle of the ice. A little dangerous for the Black Bears, but now Brett Parker skates the other way. Wilson has to come out and decides to melt it down. That'll send us to a media timeout. Black Bears up 1-0 over the Danbury Hattricks with 8:21 left to go. You're listening to Black Bears Hockey on Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton.
And Water Treatment Service Company. Let's ask these Bears how our ice is looking tonight.
La glace est vraiment parfaite.
Guys, make sure you call Arctic Bear for all of your plumbing, heating, cooling, and water treatment needs.
Man, that shoe is just showing off in that clip. What's going on, everybody? Hanging out in section 27 tonight for the season ticket holder of the game, my buddy, my pal, Peter Black. How's it going tonight, Peter?
It's going great.
Were you as excited for tonight as I was?
I was like a championship.
Really, really was, especially after that goal by speedy Gavin Yates, right?
That's right.
Well, to make the night even more complete, you get a free oil change courtesy of our friends at Avery Auto Service.
Welcome back to the action. Black Bears have a 1-0 lead, Alex. They scored on the Henny Hard Seltzer power play, but they had a couple options, even though Gavin Yates was the one to put the puck in the back of the net.
Yeah, earlier in that power play, Brooks, Nikita Ivashkin took a great shot from just on top of the circle. He had Austin Thompson standing alone, no one around him, no Danbury defender near him for 5 feet, sitting on the back door where the keeper didn't even know where he was. If Nikita passes that up and makes the extra pass rather than taking that shot, I think that goal happens a lot sooner.
Well, the Black Bears will look to add on some more with this offensive zone faceoff. Newberg wins it back. Wrist shot by D'Angelo put well high of the target. Pamelion tries to exit the zone. Held in temporarily by the Black Bears, but second opportunity for Zachary. Now dancing through the Black Bears defense. He puts one just wide of the glove of Taylor Joseph. Nifty move from the Danbury defenseman.
Yeah, what an excellent job. This game is really turning into a chess match of finesse and physicality.
Looking for a tip out in front was Pamelion from Evan Lugo, but Lugo sent it wide instead. Newberg and Boylar both look at each other about who was going to play the puck instead. And now the Black Bears clear the zone finally. Dumped right back in by Danbury as they need to get their defense out to change. And looks like we're going to have a whistle from behind the play.
Yeah, we had an offsides, Brooks.
Oh. No, I didn't even see the linesman right there, Alex. That's a great catch by you.
Yeah, it was what happened is there, as Danbury started to cycle, the defender jumped in the zone a little early. Linesman had his hand up and then gave him a chance to get back out when he continued his movement in towards the net. They called it.
Yates, Kirkby, and Lewis out with cutting and Powell. Tobias Ojik facing off with Gavin Yates. Help from Tyson Kirkby, winning the faceoff. Cutting throws a wrist shot that was blocked on the way through by Danbury. Good hit put on by Mac Lewis. Kirkby, though, still holds it in. Now on his backhand, works it back down low for the goal scorer. Steiner's up for Kirkby. Didn't get enough on it as it gets popped up straight into the air. You know, we had some members of the Rumble Ponies Booster Club here tonight. The Rumble Ponies getting ready to start their season here in a couple of months, and that was like an infield fly right in front of the net.
Yeah, Brooks says there's a foot race between Cutting and Kuznetsov down to the far side to get that puck. Cutting loses the battle.
Yeah, but luckily his defensive partner Powell was there to bail him out. Danbury still holds the puck, though, as Cutting tries to poke the puck out. Instead, I believe it was pushed out by Mac Lewis. Cutting will go off for a change. Fitzgerald on. Powell still out on the ice. Misses Falengo. Falengo, though, excellent rap check by Colin Fitzgerald. Fitzgerald this season for the Black Bears, Alex, now up to 16 assists, doing the heavy lifting in the apple column. Gavin Yates puts a shot on goal, and Wilson's forced to swallow up right there. But back to the point, Colin Fitzgerald is tied with Kyle Powell in terms of points from defensemen with 17.
And thinking about the Colin Fitzgerald, really hasn't been a frequent on the power play this season. That makes it even more impressive.
Set play off the faceoff for the Black Bears, but it will do no good as Danbury wins the faceoff. Michael Marchessault comes down the left wing side, puts it into the near side corner. And if you remember, Alex, last time these two teams faced off, we saw Danbury wrapping it around the boards to the opposite side so many times that night. Here comes Ivoshkin one-on-one, tries to get around Abdullah. Abdullah, though, does a good job sealing the Russian on the inboards behind the net. Two-on-two battle. Austin Thompson skates away with the puck, puts it back to the point for Coachman. Coachman, a shot steered aside easily by Wilson. Binghamton now up to 13 shots on goal.
Yeah, and Brooks, a shot that almost snuck in from Coachman.
Black Bears can hurry. They go two-on-one. Thompson and Ivoshkin. Thompson crosses the line, and the Black Bears are offsides. Alex, it's so loud in this building right now, you didn't even hear the whistle.
I didn't at all, Brooks. I was keeping up with the play. Didn't hear that at all. Got to disagree there, Brooks. I think that the linesman right on top of it saw it from our perch. It didn't look like he was offside, but a lot of the times that can get very, very touchy when it comes to offsides.
Let's take the Heinz Energy replay right there. I think Ivoshkin might have been a slight hair in front of Thompson on the far side where the penalty box is. Top of your screen for all of our friends listening back at home on YouTube. On your tablet, phone, TV, wherever it may be.
Smart fridge, who knows?
Yeah, if someone send a picture of you watching on your smart fridge, we'll give you some tickets to a future Black Bears game. Boylar, cross ice, too far in front of Lopez, dumped right back in. This is icing against Danbury as Walters is first to the dot.
Yeah, and Brooks, it's an unfortunate icing for Danbury. Going to keep some tired legs on the ice and give the Black Bears a chance to change, but also B, get those fresh legs out there for the big offensive zone faceoff with 5:20 left in this first period.
5:20, as Alex said, left to go here. In this one, seeing some fans make their way to the concession stand for the last call of the 2-for-1 beer special that runs through the first period here every Friday night here in Binghamton. Black Bears win the faceoff thanks to D'Angelo. A wrist shot put right into the glove of Wilson. Pavel was looking for a CNI wrist shot right from the blue line. I don't know if Wilson saw it, but he had his glove in a good spot.
Yeah, and that's why Brian Wilson, one of the best goalkeepers in this league, always in the right position. Whenever Black Bears are matched up against the hat-trick season net, you know it's going to be a good game.
Looks like everything's going to stay the same for both clubs. It'll be a set play right off the faceoff. Apologies for the microphone popping. Try to reconnect that right there just a little bit. And now Danbury goes the other way, 2-on-2. Wrist shot from Kuznetsov is blocked by Cutting, and Cutting with a little bit of an extra shove on Dimitri on the way through. Powell pays the price out of the anger from 77 dressed in white. Now Dalla throws a wrist shot, swallowed by Josh Duber. Backhander denied by Joseph down low. And now Danbury starting to generate some shots now on this offensive production. Now Yao, little hesitant, wrist shot wide of the target. Cutting and Falanga pin the puck up against the boards right in front of the Worldwide Sports Supply advertisement. Josh Neuber comes in to lend a hand, takes a nudge from Kuznetsov. And now Newberg throws it into an open spot. Danbury's there, tipped on, and Joseph steers it out of play with 4:21 left to go.
Yeah, Brooks, an excellent period so far. Back and forth action. It's always interesting when that puck gets put against the board deep in your defensive zone. Almost turns into a rugby scrum where you're trying to work, trying to use your teammates to get it out to a teammate on your side so that they can either get an offensive zone chance or clear the puck.
We're going to take a timeout, come back with more. Black Bears still up by one here in the first period with 4:21 left to go on Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton.
The Black Bears and all of our fans thank you for your sacrifices and services. If you or someone you know should be recognized as a hero of the game, visit BinghamtonBlackBears.com.
Power outages are a thing of the past when you have a Generac home standby generator installed by the team at American Electric. give them a call today or visit them on the web at aegenerators.com.
February is Dental Health Awareness Month. Broome County Dental Health Society has partnered with Triple Cities Family Dental and are tabling.
Welcome back. Check out their Fox Sports 1430. Binghamton Black Bears have a 1-0 lead. Danbury trailing the shots on goal column right now 12-14. It will be Igor Borshishev, Michael Falenga, and Dmitry Kuznetsov out for Coach Beal McCreary's club. Black Bears try to get to a loose puck, but Borshishev first to it down in the locker room corner. Kuznetsov, a nifty pass on the backhand, gets it back to the point. Gonzalez over to Abduella, looking for a tip. Borshishev hit it with his leg, not his stick, and it's sent into the corner once again. Fitzgerald with an arm around Falenga, trying to legally impede the process of the Danbury player. Borshishev tries to center out in front. Nobody home for Danbury, and Tyson Kirby will get to a loose puck, skated out of the Black Bear zone himself. Black Bears cross the line on sides. Fitzgerald's wrist shot blockered away by Wilson. Willard coming in, fanned on the second opportunity on the rebound, comes to Wilson's net. Kirkby out in front to apply pressure, and Abduella and Kirkby get familiar with each other right to the side of the goaltender.
Yeah, Brooks, and I mean, you're gonna have that happen. Kyle Gonzalez there too, really just getting comfortable with each other. Kirkby's gotta crash the net in that situation, and if you're the defenders for the hat tricks, you gotta escort him away. No harm, no foul.
Lopez, Ivashkin, and Fitzgerald now. Thompson with Lopez and Ivashkin. Boylar and Walters defensively. 3-on-2. Here comes Danbury down the left wing side. Low angle shot into the catcher's mitt of Joseph, and he hangs on no problem.
And a great save there by Joseph. That's a tough shot coming down the ice, going to your glove side, your trapper side. Got to keep that puck in the glove. Don't give up a bad rebound. That's what Danbury was looking there, hoping for a rebound. Joseph swallows it up, doesn't allow it.
Off the faceoff, Ojic tries to put a wrist shot on goal, but instead it had it blocked right away by Black Bear defender. Boylar and Lopez fighting down low near the corner. They reverse it over for JT Walters, who toe drags around the official, plays the puck back out into the neutral ice where Nikita Ivashkin self-passes it off the boards and now starts his breakout. Ivashkin, all by himself, takes a high stick. Crowd's looking for a call, they're not gonna get one. Ivashkin tries to make his way over to the bench. D'Angelo will take his spot. And now Boylar plays it up at the red line. 2-on-2 for the Black Bears. Boylar, Thompson. Boylar shot wide off the glass. Follows up his rebound for Thompson. Tries to center out in front for Lopez, but he fanned on it. Pamela on, saucers it out. And Tobias Ojic plays it over for Daniel McKittrick. McKittrick, right wing side. Low angle shot, I believe Joseph got a little bit of a blocker to it, and it'll find Chad Lopez, who's still out from this earlier shift. Lopez tries to drag and get it deep enough. Nobody's home for the Black Bears. They were in the midst of a line change. Lopez will get a new body out, and Josh Newberg will replace him. 2:05 left to go. No quarter given at the line by the Black Bears. First try, Newberg chops it out, and we have a whistle for offsides by the hat tricks.
And Brooks, we'll see if it's on the Heinz Energy replay, but Nikita gets caught up high, right in the grill, right on the nose. An intriguing no call, Brooks. That one was maybe one of the more plain high sticks you will ever see in hockey. Caught him right on the beak. You hate to say it, but that's one of the worst no calls we've seen so far this year.
Good news is Ivashkin's on the bench, did not go to the locker room. It looks like a quick fix for Elise Wilbor and the UHS training staff. See if Nikita comes out with a little more motivation next time he's out on the ice. Now Taylor Cutting, D to D over with Kyle Powell. Brett Parker down the left wing side. Parker throws it into the open corner, trying to find Newberg on the way through, but Newberg hustles after it. Parker throws it right into the crest of the goaltender, and Wilson hangs on.
And Brooks, an excellent job by the Josh Newberg that entire shift. Hustles to get the puck, throws it over to Brett Parker. Also an excellent faceoff win. If you want to hear a great interview about the art of faceoff, Cully's Good Time Coaches Show, a great interview about a month ago with Josh Newberg about the art of the faceoff. Got to check it out.
Yeah, that episode's archived on the Black Bears website and on the YouTube page as well, either or. Turnaround shot from Brent Parker after the knuckle puck from Taylor Cutting. This is glided down the length of the ice. This will be icing against Danbury as Kyle Powell is the first to the dot.
And it looks like the Black Bears are going to run the same line back. Parker, Newberg, looks like they're switching up Cutting and Powell, bringing in Fitzgerald and Coachman. And, of course, Gino D'Angelo, the homeboy, making good on his chance at professional hockey, having a great season so far. An interesting thing is talking with Coach Brant Sherwood, his first position was defenseman, Brooks, which is why you see him do that, a little bit of position flexibility on his end.
And the Black Bears also, Alex, only playing 9 forwards tonight, so 3 straight lines. No extra forward tonight for the Black Bears. Cross-ice pass from Falanga is off the stick of Kuznetsov. Parker takes a bump from Borshusev, but shrubs it off, gets off for a line change. And now the Kirkby, Yates, and Lewis line making its way out onto the ice. D'Angelo, last man out on that third line, and here comes line number 2. Final minute of the first period. Fitzgerald bumps Borshusev off the puck, but Falanga tries to turn around, a wraparound, trying to bump it off a Black Bear defender. He gets denied. We have a delayed penalty coming up as Gavin Yates crosses the line. Black Bears headed back to the power play. That puck deflected into the corner. And Colin Fitzgerald was taken down behind the play. And we're going back to the Henny Hard Seltzer power play. Looks like Colin Gonzalez is guilty. No, excuse me, it might be Igor Borshusev who's the guilty party. Looks like there will be a 2-minute minor. Second high sticking call against the Hattricks tonight.
And Brooks, it was very behind the play. Everyone had almost completely cleared out, and a stick just came up, caught Colin Fitzgerald in the face, and the official caught it just in his periphery there. Excellent call by the official to catch it that time.
Yeah, and don't forget that we're going to have our ringside reporter, Cole Parenti, talking to Gavin Yates after the end of the first period, so don't turn that dial just quite yet. Tyson Kirkby off the faceoff win, plays it over to Fitzgerald. Fitzgerald's first shot absorbed by the Danbury defense, but Tyson Kirkby with a great hustle play to chase after that puck. Nobody from Danbury knew where it was, and 17 dressed in black finds the loose change. 23 seconds left to go. Kirkby has his shot blocked on the way through by McDonald. McDonald and Kirkby fight for a loose puck. And this is working out for Danbury as it takes time off the clock. They work it over to Mac Lewis, back over to Kirkby. Black Bears try to energize something. Yates down low, 3 seconds left. Needs to center it up. Black Bears not going to get a shot off at the horn. Not the best awareness for Binghamton right there with that pile up, but they're going to carry a 1:20 of power play time into the second period.
And you see Gavin Gates there at the end just come over, sort of tap Kirkby on the shoulder, say, hey, I'm sorry about that one, buddy. Because you'd like to see Gavin Yates in that situation throw it at the bodies in front to try to get a bounce to go back into the net.
All right. It looks like we are going to get set here. Cole has grabbed Gavin Yates, and this is going to be one of 2 interviews that we have, double duty here. So we're going to send it down to our ringside reporter, Cole Parenti, along with Black Bears goal scorer, Gavin Yates.
Okay, guys, I'm here with Gavin Yates. Gavin, you had a big power play goal. Can you walk me through what you saw in that play?
Yeah, they're giving us space up top. Me and Kirk were going back and forth for a little bit. He found me over in the corner there, so it felt nice to get one in there.
Gavin, both of these teams know the impact that you're battling for first place. Can you speak on the importance of going up and scoring first?
Yeah, huge. I mean, most of these games are determined in the first 5 minutes, so if we have a good first 5, good chance of winning, so we did that.
Thank you, Gavin. Good luck the rest of the way. Brooks, Alex, I'm throwing it back to you guys in the booth.
Thank you, Cole. We appreciate it. That's the voice of Cole Parenti along with Gavin Yates, and we had already recorded with Gavin Yates earlier tonight, and we're going to play that a little bit later, so we got Gavin Yates double duty tonight as well. So don't go anywhere, folks. More to come after these messages on Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton.
Hockey is presented by Certified Textile Restoration Center.
And our youth stars tonight are Ashley Madunio, Carson Geiser, Colin Failey, Dante Mikulajczyk, Declan O'Flanagan, Garrett Watley, Gavin Marshall, John Evangelista, Jonah Lyons, Joseph Rombo, Liam Summerfield, Nathan Dance, Nathan McMahon, Philip Foster, and William Lantry. With coaches Joe Watley and John Evangelista, let's play some youth hockey. Can't play hockey without fun.
We have a hockey-filled weekend coming up next week against the Red Hawk Carolina Thunderbirds. Friday night, the Black Bears will celebrate the great state of Pennsylvania with PA Appreciation Night. And on Saturday, it'll be Teacher Appreciation Night. And on Sunday. Black Bear fans, it's now time for the Bricks Barber Company Clip of the Week.
And now I'm Hoskin one-on-one. Penalty time is up. Backhander stuff. Chance, he scores! Nikita Ivoskin, what a goal! He beats the goalie to the post. It's an even strength goal. It won't matter how you ride it. Ivoskin, second of the night.
Bricks Barber Company, located in the number 5.
Don't settle for less. Ask for American Standard Heating and Air Conditioning. American Standard, built to a higher standard.
If you're looking to install a beautiful, durable, and handcrafted countertop, call Alice James Construction. The Southern Tier's most trusted stone fabrication will design and install your dream countertop and let you choose from a premium selection of natural stones like marble, granite, or quartzite. Stone or granite countertops starting as low as $35 per square foot installed. Schedule your free quote and receive a free sink with your countertop project. Call 607-275-5495.
Canadian Pilsner.
Are you looking for a new place to live? Lofts at JC is the official housing partner of the Binghamton Black Bears and the only luxury housing provider offering both 2 and 3 bedroom units fully furnished for a modern living lifestyle. Lofts at JC is centrally located in the heart of the Tri-Cities area, located at 128 Grand Avenue in Johnson City. Housing applications are accepted online at loftsatjc.com. Once again, that's loftsatjc.com.
Magic 101.7.
Best radio station.
Keeps getting better.
Better music selection.
Best ever. Makes me feel better.
Number one for music and fun.
It's like the best ever.
Magic 101.7. 100% local.
A wreck is a wreck. An arrest is an arrest. Alcohol, cough syrup, painkillers, sleeping pills. It doesn't matter. Impaired is impaired, and it will be prosecuted. Going out tonight? Your local police will be out too. Don't drive. Get a ride. Brought to you by your New York State Stop DWI program.
Into the slot, and Kirby scores on the one-timer.
You do not want to miss 1 minute of Binghamton Black Bear action this upcoming season. With individual game tickets as low as $10 and outstanding group rates, there is no reason to wait to get your tickets to book your group. Call 607-722-7367 or check us out online at BinghamtonBlackBears.com.
As the puck below the net, Sidney pass in front, they score! 4-3 final.
Big one, boys. Who's got the sods?
No, boys. We got something better.
What do we got?
Jersey, bring us the Hennies.
Yeah!
All right, I got the Hennies.
Got the Hennies, fellas.
Start passing these out, eh?
Yeah!
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Ah, look at this bad boy. Cheers, baby.
A win like that calls for a real celebration.
Oh, yeah.
Henny's Craft Made Hard Seltzer.
If you're going to win, win with a Henny.
Are you kidding me? Bourbon flavor?
Welcome back into Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton. Brooks Hill and Alex Jones, along with Cole Parenti, down ringside as the third man of our broadcast crew. Cole will be joining the team in Alex's shoes tomorrow night on the road in Elmira, making his second opportunity on the microphone this year.
And Brooks, you know, headed into this period, it's an unfortunate situation for the Black Bears. You want your power play to start off in the offensive zone, and it's a lot easier to kill a power play when you start with a neutral ice faceoff, which is what the Danbury Hattricks are hoping to do.
And that's exactly what they are going to do. They win the faceoff. The second period brought to you by our friends at Lofts at JC. Danbury wraps this puck down the ice, and now Binghamton will chase after it with a minute 10 of Henny Hard Seltzer power play time. Ivoshkin, nifty move, gets around Falenga through the slot. Rebounds out in front. Thompson whacks at it on the third opportunity. Just poked it wide and glided down the ice by Kyle Gonzalez. Gonzalez looks over to the bench, thinks he can get off, and he will. Long second period change for the Danbury defense. And on the power play, you want to make sure your line changes are crisp, like a Henny Hard Seltzer. Matt Tuboy-Lahr will circle around the net. Centering pass out in front for Lopez. He fanned on it. Black Bears, though, still in control. Boylar loading the cannon, throws a slap shot. Kick save made by Wilson. Black Bears generating three shots on goal already here in the second period. Wrist shot out in front. Rebounds available. Wilson had no idea where it was. And Coachman fanned on a backhander on the stuff chance. That would have been his second goal of the year. 10 seconds left to go in the high sticking infraction to Igor Borshishev. Looks like the Black Bears are going to be content to let this one run out. Gavin Yates crosses the penalty box, so there's going to be one man chasing after him from behind. Yates throws on the brakes, knows he's got a man coming out, gets into the slot, puts it over to Fitzgerald, and it hops over the stick of Collin. That fresh ice, Alex, in the period, maybe playing a factor right there.
Yeah, the puck just jumped up on its edge, and he was never able to settle it fully to get a good chance at net, as we have an icing, Brooks.
Yeah, that gives us the opportunity to tell you that the second period is always brought to you by our friends over at Lofts at JC, the official housing partners of the Binghamton Black Bears, offering luxury housing with no compromises. Complex has beautiful 1, 2, and 3 bedroom units. Fill out an application today at loftsatjc.com. Faceoff won back by Yates to the forehand of Justin Coachman. Black Bears were trying to let everybody get to their set spots as Coachman just plays it off of the glass. Down low over to Lewis, back up to the point for Fitzgerald. Lewis steers it on the backhand, hits the referee's skate. And now Lewis will have to chase her after it from Evan Lugo. Hops over the stick of Justin Coachman, and another icing coming up against the Hattricks. 17:57 left to go here in period number two.
Yeah, and a long one for the Hattricks, Brooks. A little bit of gamesmanship going on here. Igor Borshev trying to get onto the bench to get a change. But unfortunately, because of the icing, he cannot make a change.
The Yates line still staying out on the ice. Borshev, as Alex said, taking his sweet time, making his way back over.
Looked like he might have accidentally grabbed the wrong stick, Brooks.
Accidentally on purpose. Pamela on gets help from the faceoff, and now Borshev with the new stick tries to connect on a stretch pass, but Walters and Boylar do a good job of interrupting that, but it will be the Black Bears' turn to ice the puck as Boylar's pass is a little bit errant and doesn't connect with anybody.
Yeah, Boylar trying to get a tip across that red line. Unfortunately for him, the forwards vacated as he made that path down the middle, which will allow for the Danbury Hattricks to get a line change out there, get some fresh legs. 17:45 left in the second period.
Hattricks win the faceoff. DeBennett wins it back to Abdwella. Abdwella looking for a tip, none provided. Gonzalez and Lewis both slap at it. Puck becomes available in the slot. Can the Black Bears push it out? They do not. Abdwella holds the line. McKittrick steers around the net. Turnaround shot saved by Joseph, hugging the post. Ratcliffe back up to Abdwella. Abdwella, Gonzalez playing catch. Gonzalez got a tip out in front, I believe off the foot of McKittrick. Puck still in the zone. Black Bears want to desperately clear the zone. And now Kirkby is Gates it past the red line himself, glides it around, one hand style, centering out in front, but Abdullah gets to a puck, puts it into the curtain, and out of play.
And Brooks, an excellent job by Kirkby getting, creating space, sliding past everybody, and getting that pass, trying to get it on the stick of Gavin Yates, which forces the deflection out of play in the offensive zone faceoff.
Josh Newberg, Gino D'Angelo, and Brett Parker, the forwards for the Black Bears. Falenga, Kuznetsov, and Borshasev for the hat tricks. One back by Newberg. Powell throws a wrist shot. Got a tip, but too far wide. Now D'Angelo gets to a loose puck right in front of the Zamboni door. Parker, turnaround shot on the short side. Nowhere close. Kuznetsov chasing after it. Chucked from behind from Taylor Cutting. Danbury wraps it around, but Taylor Joseph coming out of his crease. Sets it up on a tee for Kyle Powell, and now 200-foot play coming up for the Black Bears. Powell plays it off the boards for Cutting, and Cutting will glide it down. A little bit errant, but he holds the line, making up for the pass. He gets sealed away, and now Brett Parker sends his man into the boards, but penalty's coming up. As high sticking is going to be the call. Third high stick infraction called by the officials tonight.
Yeah, it looks like it's going to be on Brett Parker for the high stick. Lots of sticks getting up, and that's what's going to happen in an aggressive game for teams that like to attack defensively. A lot of those sticks start to just accidentally miss the stick at the last minute and get up high.
Time of the penalty, 3:40 into the second period. Brett Parker guilty of a two-minute infraction for high sticking. And finishing his check, his stick just rides up the body, makes contact with the face, and right in front of the official, easy call to make. Black Bear, go ahead,
Alex. I actually think it happened before the body check. I think it happened right in front of the Excite Motorsports dashboard.
Chad Lopez tries to skate in shorthanded. His progress is impeded. Gets on the back check, though, against Jared Yao. And now Michael Falenga crossing the line for Danbury. Starting skating backwards. Pass knocked away by Thompson out of the zone, and the Black Bears will push the puck a little further. Now they get it deep enough. If they need to get some bodies, they can. Thompson's calling for one, and Tyson Kirkby runs into the linesman getting onto the ice. Gets one body out of three. Kirkby towing the line. Forces Yao to misplay it. Lopez has his progress impeded. Kirkby self-pass, running out of real estate, taken down, no call.
Oh, an excellent shot, Brooks, by Kirkby. Kirkby gets taken down to the ice, wrapped up and yanked down, and even as he gets wrapped up and yanked down, he gets his stick on the puck, spins it around, and gets a shot on Wilson, which probably would have been the top goal of the year if it goes in the back of the net.
Take a look at the Heinz Energy replay here. Kirkby taken down. I like the no call there, but a good wraparound chance. I'm going to credit that one to just losing your edge. I don't think it's a tripping call. I think maybe it's just maybe the sticks touching together, or the skates touching.
See, I think, Brooks, he had a little bit of the jersey there, which caused that spin. But Black Bears are happy to be able to get an offensive zone faceoff to kill more time off this power play for the Hattricks.
Crowd growing a little restless here. Halfway through the Brett Parker high-sticking minor. Joseph coming out of his net to stop the puck so Danbury can't wrap it around the boards. That puck rides the glass. Linesman behind the play along with the referee both point out that that puck went off the glass and into the netting, so no delay of game.
Yeah, Gonzalez was really partitioning hard there for that to be a delay of game. Linesman all over, though, on the tip out of play.
Northeastern Striping Corporation penalty kill is 1-for-1 tonight for the Black Bears. McKittrick will take this faceoff for the Hattricks, trying to win it back to one of his defensemen. Walters and Marchessault with a couple of stick taps for each other. One back to the point. Kuznetsov one touches it over for McDonald. Kuznetsov begging for the puck. Gonzalez looking for a shot. Cleared out, but held in by McDonald. Now Gonzalez, top of the umbrella, back over to McDonald, slap shot, don't think made it there. McKittrick chasing after it, running out. Have to pass it over to Kuznetsov. They work it back up top. Kuznetsov, shot, glove save by Joseph, and he swallows up the rebound as well.
And an excellent save by Taylor Joseph. It hops up into his glove, hits the ice, and then he's able to jump all over it.
We're going to take a timeout, come back. 16 seconds left to go on the penalty kill for the Black Bears. More to come after these messages on Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton.
Section 4 Unified Basketball, First Baptist Church of JC, International Paper, Binghamton Baseball Booster Club, EPAC, Amelia Palermo Birthday Party, BU Sport Management, Theta Tau, Danbury's Fan Club, Justin Sprout Group, Avery Auto Service, Serve Pro, Brew Bituminous Products, Southern Tier Hockey Association, Binghamton Hockey Booster Club, Visions Federal Credit Union, and our season ticket holders.
Welcome back to Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton. The Learning Ladder Child Care Centers are located in Endicott and Johnson City. They enroll children ages 6 weeks to 12 years old. Call 607-770-3806 for an appointment today to walk through one of their facilities. Come join their family and they will help your child grow. And friendly reminder for all of our friends listening around the concourse on the televisions, maybe still at the concession stand line, that we have the postgame skate today, immediately following tonight's contest.
Yeah, and Brooks, an excellent opportunity to interact with the players, get on the ice and skate around, have some great fun. Josh Newberg wins the puck. It's on Colin Fitzgerald's stick. He's content just to sit behind the net, park it. Loses the puck, however, and the Danbury Hattricks are able to get the puck around, drop it in behind the net with 5 seconds left on the power play.
Yeah, a little indecisive for the Black Bears. It looked like the guys out in front of Fitzgerald were blocking his path down the ice to shoot it all the way. Brevet Parker has returned. Black Bears' penalty kill is 2-for-2 on the night. Parker along with D'Angelo and Newberg out, and now D'Angelo will push the puck out into the neutral zone. Danbury's offsides. They have to touch up. Marchessault puts a hit onto Justin Coachman. And another high stick as Josh Newberg caught that one. That's a follow through. So that one's a good no call by the officials right there on the play of the puck. If you play the puck, you're allowed to follow through. And Fitzgerald will just glide it down, get off for a line change as he has been on the ice for a while.
Yeah, an excellent shift from Fitzgerald. Unfortunately, Sforz did not get out of his way on that clearing attempt.
Now, Falanga coming down the right wing side, has it on his backhand, forced behind the net, double teamed by Cutting and Kirkby. And now it'll be Gavin Yates matching up against Falanga. Yates will pick his pocket, skate behind his own net to get some separation. Daniel Amesbury veers off, and now Yates crosses all three lines by himself. Yates in, taken down. Referee ready to blow the whistle, and he finally will. Mac Lewis, Amesbury, just pushing and shoving. Nothing's going to come of it. And another opportunity for Yates. Hops his stick over at the last second.
Yeah, an unfortunate one for Yates. He took a hard body at through, got pushed into the post at the end of this attack. Amesbury does a good job tracking back, keeping his stick on it, catches the side of the post as he goes down. Hard, hard hit.
Black Bears not taking the bait right there, Alex.
Well, here's the thing too, Brooks. It's a smart move because Amesbury is going after some very good players for the Black Bears. Mac Lewis, one of the best penalty killers, a spark plug folder forward. You're trading Amesbury, who's giving very few minutes a night and who's very explicitly what it is, and trading out one of your forwards who is going to lose out on the opportunity as we change the location of this faceoff.
That's really unfortunate. Black Bears with a shot on goal. I took a look at the Heinz Jr. replay. Yates was actually able to put that on goal. Just good save by Wilson. Now Cutting throws a shot from the halfway point of the ice and blocked away by Wilson. And it looks like Ratcliffe lost his stick in the process.
So shattered it.
Yeah, right in half. Black Bears try to take advantage. Yates stuff chance. Second opportunity from Lewis and Wilson. Okay, now Mac Lewis, Tobias Ogic start throwing haymakers out in front. Lewis and Ogic start the wrestling match. Oh. and Ojek wants his team to, quote, Alex, wake up.
And then got confused at which penalty box he was in.
Yeah, Mac Lewis was shoved right into Brian Wilson in front of the net. If we get a look at the Heinz Energy replay on that one. Quick bout between the two sides. Ojek rejoining the team after some time away. And now trying to energize his club by dropping the mitts with Mac Lewis. So here's the replay. Kirkby centers up for Yates. First chance, no. And then Ratcliffe pushes Lewis into the goaltender. And then Ojek gets into the face of Lewis, and then they just start trading blows right away.
And Ojek gets the advantage. He gets the sweater over Mac Lewis's head. And always a disadvantage in a fight when you cannot see your opponent, Brooks. I know this may shock some people, but never good when you can't see him. Ojek gets about four or five good shots in. Mac Lewis gets a couple more shots in, and then it ends up in a wrestling match on the ground.
Take another look at it from our vantage point up here in the press box. Referee right on top of it, blew the whistle immediately. And then Ojek and Lewis just drop one glove each, and then the other one just kind of flies off on the opportunity.
Looks like we got a little banter happening between the benches, between managers, Brooks, as Dansbury's coach in a full Scully and hat moves over towards the Black Bears side.
See if we can get a camera on that from our friends down in the video room. It'd be from our opposite side, or in between the benches.
Unfortunately, Brooks, the benches happen to be on the hard cam side, and which makes it a little bit harder to grab this sort of action.
A lot of the Black Bears faithful.
They're sending someone to the penalty box on the... There's a lot of pointing and a lot of talking going on in between the benches with the men in the orange arm singlets.
There we go. There's the camera looking down the line. I almost wish this was like the KHL, and during timeouts, you could send the camouflage guy out on the ice with a camera to rove. Get it around.
It looks like they might be sending both.
Making for some great television and radio right now. I wish we had a microphone down there and we could pick up on what the referees are trying to lay down right now, but.
I'm wondering if they're sending both managers to the locker room a little early right now, Brooks. A lot of pointing behind the benches and things like that, which we are unable to get because of the fans who are standing right in front of the boxes.
Trying to see what's going on. Tyson Kirkby's trying to hand signal over to the penalty box to let Mac Lewis what's going on. Mac Lewis has been sitting down for a couple minutes now. Now starting to make his gear back on.
Lots of confusion from everyone, Brooks, including us in the Jeff Kies Auto Center broadcast booth.
Momentarily pause and silence from the crowd.
Looks like we have a little bit of a takeover on the video board, Brooks. I don't know what's going on. It looks like both. So right now, Danbury's manager is down at the end of the bench, headed into the locker room area. I don't know if it's the same with Brant Sherwood or not.
You know, Tyler Jurich is acting as a player assistant tonight for the first time, dressed in a suit behind the bench for the Black Bears, trying to see what we can muscle up here. Let's see what Frank Perney has to say. Out in front, Black Bears try to extend their lead. Out in front for Ivashkin, sent it wide. Now Taylor Cutting chasing after it. So both head coaches have been given game misconducts.
Well, and here's the interesting thing, Coach Brooks. Their coach is still hanging out in outside the tunnel, right on the stands watching the game. I don't know. I believe both coaches are supposed to head to the locker room and stay there.
Absolutely leveling hit from Taylor Cutting right at the blue line on Jacob Ratcliffe. Welcome to the Fed, Jacob Ratcliffe. Now Ivoshkin brushes one off. Teams will trade. So five for fighting, and then both coaches get game misconducts. So that's how that one has been drawn up. Bill McCreary hanging out in, it looks like, row A down there. And I don't know. I think that's section 19, Alex.
Yeah, it looks to be, Brooks.
Thompson shows a shot off of the blocker of Wilson. Lopez to the rebound. Gets brushed off, knocked down by Marchessault, and out come the hat tricks, 4-on-3. Dropping it back for Marchessault. They try to center up, but a great stick on the back check by JT Walters. Excellent defensive play by 24 in black. Threat's not over. They had DeBennett out in front. Ivoshkin tries to lay a hit. Lopez takes down Marchessault, and now the Black Bears go the other way. So now, after all of that, referees letting both teams play a little bit here in the second period. Stuff chance denied by Wilson from Boylar. Boylar sends a man down into the boards. Physicality picking up here in the second period, Alex.
Oh, for sure, Brooks. The intensity has been ramped up to 11.
Black Bears momentarily offsides. They need to touch up. Newberg now hears it from the official. Danbury with control of the puck. 10:50 left to go here in the period. Stretch pass off the stick of Falenga as he can't control it. Fitzgerald trying to find Newberg right at the line. Black Bears cross on sides. Brett Parker low angle, throws it into the chest of the goaltender and melted down.
And Brooks, you can feel the palpability of this matchup of the Titans. These are the two top teams in the Empire Division, and you can feel it here in the arena. Fans are almost on top of each other trying to catch the action. A fully sold out arena. We only had really standing room only left by the end of this, and just a very, very intense game so far.
Josh Newberg, last man into the faceoff dot. But it'll be Evan Lugo who wins this one from Danbury. Falenga crosses the blue line in his own end. And a one-touch pass from Amesbury. Throws Coachman into the boards, but from his knees, Coachman makes the play, and the Black Bears skate away 3-on-3. Cross-ice corner dumping. A great play from Fitzgerald on the stick lift, and Brett Parker on the back check to end the odd man rush going the other way. Amesbury, a slap shot, denied by Joseph.
It's a goal.
Off the back end, and it's in. It takes a funny bounce off of the boards. And I believe that's going to be a Daniel Amesbury goal out in front. It goes off the skate of Taylor Joseph. Just an unfortunate bounce for the Black Bears.
100%, Brooks. You got to tighten up to the post there. Just goes off the skate of Taylor Joseph, throws it in behind. As he tries to get tight to that, hits his skate, rolls back in as the Danbury player crashes into the legs of Taylor Joseph. Puck was already over the line, however, no goaltender interference there.
10:08 left to go, and Daniel Amesbury has tied the game up at 1. A shot that was saved by Joseph, put into the corner. Takes a funny bounce, off the inboards. Took a funny bounce, and instead, Evan Lugo gets the assist. It's an even strength goal, and the game is tied.
Yeah, Brooks, 9:59 left in the second period. Looks like we're going to be headed to a timeout here. Big moment for the Black Bears. Can they muster and get ahead of the lead, or will they drop behind a goal?
Well, we'll find out after these messages on Fox Sports 1430 when we come back.
Scored it.
Alex Jones on the call here, and Daniel Amesbury has tied the game up with a slap shot that goes off of the skate of Taylor Joseph. An even strength goal at 9:52. And yeah. Now we are tied at one.
Yeah, and Brooks, just a unlucky bounce that jumps off the skate of Taylor Joseph into the back of the net. It almost is one of those where if he doesn't get back on his line faster, it actually it works out better for him.
Orange is gross.
Held in at the point by Taylor Cutting, and now Ratcliffe skating in his own zone. Almost had it stolen away by Ivashkin. Can only throw it out into neutral ice. And now we have Ivashkin double shifting in the absence of Mac Lewis, along with Tobias Ogic, who's in the penalty box for fighting. We'll see which team gets the jump coming after the fight altercation and the coaches being thrown out of the contest. That puck's thrown in on the delayed offsides. And Borchashev did not get the memo from the linesman. And now it'll be a neutral zone faceoff coming up.
Yeah, and Brooks, this is going to be a big moment for both teams. Really going to be interesting to see what happens here. Late line shift for the Black Bears, taking advantage of the offensive, the home team line change. Lopez, Ivashkin, and Thompson, Walters, and Boylar.
Lopez tries to push it forward, but Thompson wasn't in the right spot. Danbury wraps it in around the boards. They have tied the game up. They have 21 shots. Binghamton has 24, and so far Danbury's the only side to score here in the period. Lopez getting peppered by Marchessault, but that puck's going to be thrown out of the zone. Walters will chase after it and do the smart thing, go to his defensive partner, and puck chipped back into the Danbury side. Walters fans on one. Boylar will play McKittrick down low in the corner. Centering pass denied by Joseph on the paddle down. Thompson backhands one out into the neutral ice, but Pamela on in the right spot gets to the loose puck. Boylar is peppered from behind, almost put it too far in front of Walters. Now the Black Bears try to soccer style this one out of the zone. Look out, here come the hat tricks. Now Filenga dropping it back for McKittrick and blocked out in front by Walters. Walters has blocked a couple of shots here this period, Alex, doing an excellent job on the shift. Ivashkin beats out the icing. Pamela on thought that it was a shoe-in, but one of the Russian Rockets for the Black Bears beats it out. Stretch pass going the other way as the tempo starts to pick up here in period number two. Centering pass is denied, and Joseph, this time hugging the post, just puts his glove on top of it to melt it down.
Yeah, Brooks, a good job by Joseph there. Slow it down, let your team get their full line change out there, and then allow them to get a defensive zone faceoff rather than putting that puck back into play and keeping it going.
Filenga, Lugo, and Amesbury, the goal scorer, out there for the hat tricks. And Justin Coachman comes in to lend a hand as the center's tied up. Fitzgerald pushes the puck past the Danbury defense. Parker gets on the forecheck, lays a hit, but Danbury will clear the zone, and now Filenga will go one on two. He crosses over the line, left it back at home, and now Parker run into, and this should be a interference call against Brendan Dowler, as Brett Parker did not have the puck. The Black Bears are headed back to the Henny Hard-Seltzer power play.
And Brett Parker down injured right now in front of the Black Bears' back. Got caught right in the rib cage. Incredibly uncomfortable area to get caught with a stick. Still down on a knee right in front of the bench.
12:17, the time and the penalty. Now each side has taken one penalty in the frame, Alex, as Brendan Dowler gets sent to the penalty box. That'll end our streak of high sticking infractions. This time it's Dowler for interference, and he's going to sit for two.
Yeah, and just catches him in the butt of the stick right in the rib cage. Just does not feel good, Brooks. That's a soft part of the body. There's not a lot of protection there.
Faceoff won by the Black Bears as Gates circles behind the offensive net. Drops it back over for Kirkby. Kirkby in the slot, wrist shot, save made by Wilson. And now Marchessault and Kirkby start to push and shove out in front. Also worth noting, Mac Lewis and Tobias Ogic return from their 5-minute fighting majors.
Yeah, Brooks, and that's a big Ojic is on there, penalty kill for the Danbury hat-tricks. Mac Lewis is a guy on the top power play line. Good to see them both back on the ice. Yates, Newberg, and who's that on the far left side, Brooks?
That's Mac Lewis.
Mac Lewis.
Yep, Danbury wins the faceoff and right away throws it out of the zone. Joseph sets it up on a tee. And Colin Fitzgerald will retreat it behind his own net. Cross ice pass over for Lewis. Got a lot of room on that right wing side. Circles behind the net, but had it stolen away by Abduella. Off the glass and out. Yates can't play it at the line. Danbury gets some fresh bodies out on the ice. They get two out of the four. And now Fitzgerald crossing over the blue line. Has his progress impeded? McDonald tries to play it out. He will. Look out. Falenga coming away shorthanded, but Gavin Yates does get back to take away the breakaway chance. Mac Lewis in front of his own bench. One hand slaps it over to Tyson Kirkby. Kirkby back over to Yates. Yates, a lot of room in the slot. Drops it right back over for Kirkby. Throws a wrist shot that was blocked on the way through by Yao. Kirkby circles the wagon. Puck still available. Danbury can't clear the zone. 45 seconds left to go. Newberg in. His shot's blocked. A race to the blue line. And Newberg plays it off the glass and handballed out of the zone by John McDonald. And this should be an offensive zone faceoff, and it is coming up for the Black Bears with the second unit coming out.
But Danbury's happy they're able to get their third penalty kill unit out there. Amesbury. It's just going to be one of those times, Brooks. 36 seconds left. Can the Black Bears bite down on their mouthpieces, grit it out for 36 seconds and get a good offensive opportunity here?
Lopez tries to push it forward. Thompson gets to the loose puck behind the net, plays it back for Boylar. Boylar, turn around looking for a tip. None provided. Going to be wrapped around the boards, held in soccer style by Powell. Ivashkin on the back end, oh, down low to Lopez. Tries to center up through the blue paint. Thompson's pushed down from behind. Nobody knows where the puck is. Boylar finds it behind the net. Self-pass out in front, trying to find somebody dressed in black. Finally, Boylar gets it back, throws a shot. Got a tip from Thompson out in front, but Wilson makes the save. 3 seconds left to go in the Dowler penalty. Brendan's up and ready. Power play time is up. Turnaround from Thompson is fanned on. Puck still available. And Evan Lugo gets to it, but turns it right back over for Ivashkin. Nets off its pegs. Nobody seems to know. Ivashkin lost his stick in the process. And Danbury tries to outstretch the pass over to Ojek. Ojek crosses the line on signs, they say. Lugo in the slot, but back-checked by Brett Parker and pushed right off the puck. Yao punts it back in. Danbury touches up. They're still offsides. Ojek doesn't see, and now he does. And we finally have a whistle. And the net is off its pegs, and a very odd time to blow that whistle dead.
You gotta expect that it's gonna be a neutral zone faceoff here, right, Brooks? I mean, you're not gonna call it in deep in the defensive zone and give Danbury Hattricks a deep offensive zone here. Looks like we're moving it up into the offensive zone of the Black Bears for this faceoff to the right of Brian Wilson. And turns out I was right all along, Brooks. We're going neutral zone right in front of the Danbury Hattricks bench.
1-1 contest, 5:05 left to go. Black Bears do not score on the third power play of the night. They are 1-for-3 on the Henny Hard Seltzer man advantage. Binghamton will travel to Elmira tomorrow night. That'll be at 6:30. Triple City's Family Dental pregame show will be at 6:15. Borchashev and Newberg tie up, and Newberg pushes it back. Fitzgerald and Coachman, first defensive grouping tonight, out there with the third line. Newberg on the touch pass over to D'Angelo. Fitzgerald, nice display of stick handling. Parker fanned on it partially. Held in, though, by Newberg. Throws a wrist shot. That goes off of the shin of Borchashev. That's got to hurt. Good forecheck by D'Angelo just to get the puck deep enough still, forcing Danbury to go a 200-foot game playing with it in their own zone. Dowler fresh out of the penalty box, plays it over for Kuznetsov. Yao goes one touch over to Borchashev, slap shot off the stick of Fitzgerald into the corner. Shot from the point, never made it through, and now D'Angelo gets over to the blue line, driving it back over for Gavin Yates. Yates starting and stopping. Stick handling in a phone booth is Yates. Matched up against Dowler. Here comes the double. And now it finds a stick of Parker. Throws a shot. Denied by Wilson. Second chance from D'Angelo is stuffed. And a power attempt from D'Angelo out in front is knocked down by Brian Wilson. And now the Black Bears are headed to a media timeout. 4:04 left to go here. 1-1 contest. 4 minutes left to go in the second period on Fox Sports 1430.
Head on over to BigtonBlackBears.com or call the office at 607-722-7367 and reserve your seats now for a great weekend of Black Bears. Talk.
Still Alex Jones, Cole Parenti making his way down ringside to grab an interview. Black Bears and Hattricks are tied at 1. 4 minutes left to go. Shots on goal, 28 for Binghamton, 21 for Danbury.
And just a shooting gallery opened up there, Brooks, during the power play, the last chance. Brian Wilson doing an excellent job standing on his head, keeping the puck out of the back of the net. Nikita Ivashkin got a couple good wraparound chances in front of the net. Excellent job by the Black Bears.
Yates, Kirkby, Lewis out with Walters and Boylar. Somebody's looking to be the difference maker. Face off, one back by Lucas DeBennett. Pushed out into the neutral zone by Danbury. Black Bears touch up. Tyson Kirkby, F1. In as the four, this puck glided out of the zone. If this isn't on goal, it will be icing. And JT Walters right on the dot. And offensive zone faceoff coming up for the Black Bears.
Yeah, just an awkward jump off the dasher. It gets out of the way, unfortunately for the Danbury Hattricks. Skips away from Mathieu Boylar, who looked like he was about to play that puck, ends up icing.
Black Bears win the faceoff. Boylar from the point. Has his shot absorbed by Gavin Yates out in front. A little bit of friendly fire for the Black Bears. Yates running out of real estate as he was going east and west. As the puck is put out into the neutral zone, Marchessault crosses over the line. McKittrick and DeBennett had run into each other right at the blue stripe. Now the Black Bears will try to start and go the other way. Tape-to-tape pass for Gavin Yates. The lefty puts a shot, took a little bit off of that shot, and I believe Wilson, a little bit of a late reaction, still makes the pad save, though. Black Bears try to touch up and connect with the pass, but instead chipped away. Cutting and McKittrick have their sticks tied up. And now Cutting takes his look up ice. He's going to wrap this one around the boards for Ivashkin in the open corner. Ivashkin chases after it, jumps around a hit from Pamela on, shoves off a second attempt. Puck still available inside the faceoff dot. Ivashkin has it behind the net. Here comes the stuff chance. Rolled off his stick. Yateso to the rebound. Collects the loose change. Plays it off the boards for Thompson. Thompson's had it hop over his stick a couple times tonight. Runs into the referee. Sends a man down to the ice. Ivashkin on the backhand. That time it rolled off the stick of Nikita. Kept in the zone by Powell. Powell thought about the shot. Now looks for a tip. Blocked on the way through by McDonald. And Powell's going to have to skate after this one to get back. 2-on-1. Ogic throws a shot. Turned aside by Joseph. Lopez to the loose change. Back out into the neutral zone. 3-on-2 for the Black Bears the other way. Powell was trying to get sprung, but stretch pass. No icing. Ogic first man to it. Into the far side. Low angle shot. Joseph makes the save. Wanted to reach for it, but instead finds the stick of Chad Lopez. Getting a sense of a little bit of tired bodies out on the ice for the Black Bears. Now Lopez will throw it in, cross corner, right off the glass, right down to the ice. Thompson and Ivashkin getting off. Lopez will be the next man for the Binghamton forwards. Fitzgerald lost his stick in the process, and we're going to have a penalty by Danbury once again with 1:33 left to go. It looks like it would be slashing is the call.
That's a pretty easy one to call, Brooks. Two hands right into the body. The stick goes away. That's one the officials are looking for, and they're going to see every time. When you see that lumbar separate from the body after a two-hander like that, it's the easiest call in the world for them to make.
Take a look at the Heinz Ranger replay, and Fitzgerald just had it whacked clean right out of his hands by Kuznetsov. Kuznetsov's going to have to sit for at least 93 seconds left in the period, Alex, to see if the Black Bears can generate another power play goal before the horn. Newberg gets taken down off the faceoff as he was trying to play it. Fitzgerald can't hold the line, and Joseph will come back and play it himself, and seeing Joseph a little bit more cautious coming out of his net playing the puck now after that Amesbury goal off the inboards. Gavin Yates through center ice, crossing. Waiting for everybody to get to their spots. Yates loaded the cannon instead, gave it back to Fitzgerald. Over to Yates once again, shot, that one off the mask. Kirkby paws it down, controls the puck, 1 minute left to go. Fitzgerald back up at the blue line, playing catch with Kirkby, looking for a tip from his college teammate out in front, sent wide, off target. Kirkby down low for Lewis. The Lakers will play catch with each other. Takes a look up at the clock, 38 seconds left to go. Fitzgerald back over to Yates on the far side. Yates trying to dance around his man, create some separation. Filanga staying with the puck. Out in front, Newberg denied by Wilson. Yates is tired, he's at the end of the shift. This line's been out there the whole time. Lewis chasing after it, thrown around the boards. Yates sees that it's coming, but Filanga gets to a loose puck instead. 15 seconds left to go. Black Bears are gonna go for a line change. 10 seconds remaining in the period. Yao throws it off. Black Bears start a final push. 5 seconds left to go. Kyle Powell takes a look up. Ivoshkin at the blue line, runs out of time. 28 seconds left to go in the Henny Hard Seltzer power play as Yao and Ivoshkin get in each other's grill at the end of the horn, and we are tied at one after 40 minutes of play.
Yeah, and Brooks, in a back and forth period there with a tying goal from Daniel Amesbury. You'd like to see a better opportunity there for the Black Bears. Hopefully you can get your guys out. Gavin Yates had a chance to change there, and you kind of wish he had been able to do that where he can get that change and get a shot on net.
All right, looks like we have our ringside reporter standing by. It's going to be Chad Lopez, Cole's special guest. So go ahead and take it away, Cole.
All right, guys, I'm here with forward Chad Lopez. Chad, you guys gave up a fluky goal, but you didn't seem rattled. How did your team not let that affect them?
Yeah, you know, we just got to play hard, come back. You got to have a good shift after a goal against, and you just got to put it behind you and keep skating hard.
Chad, you've had some amazing chemistry with your line mates, Nikita Ivashkin and Austin Thompson. How have you guys been able to click so well?
They're both really good players. Start to read and react off of them, find some chemistry, and you just start working well together.
All right, Chad, last question before I let you go. Everyone knows the importance of this game. The Binghamton Black Bears finish tonight in first place. If you guys do what next period?
If we win the period.
That's all I needed to hear. Chad, good luck rest of the way. Alex, Brooks, you guys heard it here first. Win the period, take the lead. I'm throwing it back to you.
Thank you, Cole. Great job, as always. I want to thank Chad for his time before he makes his way into the locker room. While the Excited Motorsports Intermission Report is right around the corner, make sure to stay with us here on Fox Sports 1430 after these messages.
All right. By the way, tonight is another free post-game skate with Pendleton Black Bears. But you need skates to go on the ice. If you didn't bring your skates, call home. Exxon will bring some skates out for you tonight. They'll be doing it again on Sunday. Listen to 98.1 The Hunt on Monday.
I'm all black. We have a hockey field weekend coming up next week against the Red Hawk Carolina Thunderbirds. Friday night, the Black Bears will celebrate the great state of Pennsylvania with PA Appreciation Night. And on Saturday, it'll be Teacher Appreciation Night. And on Sunday. Black Bear fans, it's now time for the Rick's Barber Company Clip of the Week.
Now I've lost it. Time is up. Backhander stops. Chance, he scores! Nikita Ivoshkin, what a goal! He beats the goalie to the post. It's an even strength goal. It won't matter how you're riding. Ivoshkin's second of the night.
Rick's Barber Company located in the number 5.
All right, 364. They'll be coming back in April. Final regular season home game at night. Some of the winners get a photo of the site on the 21st of the 10th floor. All right. So, I think we need to get a little bit of cheer for our team from Black Bear.
Second period intermission report. Brooks Hill and Alex Jones along for the ride here tonight. Danbury ties the game up at one. We'll get to the goal in just a little bit, but period stats, 14 shots on goal for the Black Bears for a game total of 30. Danbury adds 10 more in the second period, and now they have a team total of 23. Danbury does not score on their power play opportunity. As they had a Brett Parker sit down for 2 minutes. Black Bears do not score on their first penalty of the period, but now they still have 28 seconds remaining in the second Danbury infraction of the frame. So total stats for power play 0 for 2 for Danbury. Binghamton is 1 for 3. And that's where we stand special teams with 28 seconds left to go. And the Demetrius Kuznetsov minor for slashing.
And you have to think, Brooks, that this is going to end up being a penalty that also gets killed. 28 seconds left in a neutral zone faceoff starting at center ice. That's going to be a tough one to muster for the Black Bears getting shots on that. With that little time left, you're going to have to come up with some sort of set play in the locker room. Interesting to see how they'll start this one off.
Those are a look at the Columbian Mutual Life stat sheet. Columbian Mutual Life has been protecting families in the southern tier for over 140 years. When we come back, we're going to have the Binghamton Hockey Booster Club highlights, talk about maybe the keys to the game, and a look ahead at the out-of-town scoreboard. So more to come after these messages on Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton.
JC.com. Once again, that's lofts at JC.com.
Better music selection.
Best ever. Makes me feel better.
Number one for music and fun.
It's like the best ever.
Magic 1017, 100% local.
A wreck is a wreck. An arrest is an arrest. Alcohol. Cough syrup, painkillers, sleeping pills. It doesn't matter. Impaired is impaired, and it will be prosecuted. Going out tonight? Your local police will be out too. Don't drive. Get a ride. Brought to you by your New York State Stop DWI program.
The slot, and Kirby scores on the one-timer.
You do not want to miss 1 minute of Binghamton Black Bear action this upcoming season. With individual game tickets as low as $10 and outstanding group rates, there is no reason to wait to get your tickets to book your group. Call 607-722-7367 or check us out online at binghamtonblackbears.com.
Below the net, Zinnery pass in front, they score! 4-3 final.
Big one, boys. Who's got the suds?
No, boys. We got something better.
What do we got?
Jersey, bring us the Hennies.
Yeah!
All right, I got the Hennies.
Got the Hennies, fellas. Start passing these out, eh?
Yeah!
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Ah, look at this. this bad boy. Cheers, baby.
A win like that calls for a real celebration.
Oh, yeah. Henny's Craft Made Hard Seltzer.
If you're gonna win, win with a Henny.
Are you kidding me? Bourbon flavor?
www.hennyscraftmadehardseltzer.com. Call them at 607-341-7588 or visit them at their storefront at 408 Front Street in Vestal. Now time to go ahead and take a look at the out-of-town scoreboard. We have some updates for you. Motor City now leads Port Huron 3-0 on the road. Columbus in a 2-1 bout with the Delaware Thunder. Thunder playing the River Dragons atop of the FPHL very tightly. Tonight, Elmira and Watertown tied at 1, and Mississippi leading Carolina. Carolina comes in for a 3-game set next weekend, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday against the Black Bears, and the Seawolves leading the Thunderbirds 3-1 at home. So some impressive scores going around the league. We'll take our final look at it when we have the La Quinta Inn and Suites postgame show. But, Alex, anything jumping out to you before we get to the third period?
Yeah, Mississippi over Carolina is a big one. Carolina is a powerhouse in the Continental Division. And Mississippi getting out a 3-1 lead very early on them is huge for that division. Can change some things up. Motor City over Port Huron in a huge rivalry game for them on the road, up 3-0. Another big lead. And Elmira and Watertown deadlocked is one of the more least shocking things that I've heard in recent history.
All right, and that's the voice of Alex Jones. And we come back, third period presented by American Standard Heating and Air Conditioning, after these messages on Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton. Welcome back to the third period presented by American Standard Heating and Air Conditioning. They are built to a higher standard. Both coaches received game misconducts tonight, Alex, and now both teams looking to dig in a 1-1 contest going into the final 20 minutes.
Yeah, and we have Ruiz and Jurich as head coaches at the moment. Maybe a glimpse into both players' futures, as they're known as cerebral players on the ice. So an interesting dynamic. And Jurich are running the line changes for both. Two guys who know their teams incredibly well and have a lot of time in this league.
Black Bear in the power, 28 more seconds, so maybe one more entry into the zone. Then Kuznetsov, very dangerous, would be coming out of the box. He has 17 goals this year.
I'll tell you what, Kuznetsov is one of their best offensive players. He's a big on net and really drive it. Probably soft hand. I agree, Brooks, a real threat that the Black Bears are going to have to contest with on the box.
Thompson, Lopez, Ivashkin, along with Powell and Boylar will start and probably finish off the Henny Hard Seltzer power play to begin the third period. And we are officially underway here in the third period. Black Bears with control of the puck on the stick of Kyle Powell. Running out of room, he's just forced to play it off the glass. Takes a run off of the kick plate onto the stick of Ivashkin, centering out in front, and Thompson didn't get anything on it. He had the back of the net wide open. 4 seconds left to go. Powell throws a wrist shot into the glove. 1 second left to go in the Kuznetsov penalty. And a golden opportunity for Binghamton right there to take the lead less than 30 seconds into the period.
And Brooks, I think that actually hit off a Danbury defender right in front of the net. I think he just got the tip of a stick on it, which caused that puck to get on an edge a little bit and just skip over Thompson's stick. He couldn't bury it in the back of the net.
Dimitri is coming out of the box, and here comes the stretch pass, held in, though, by Fitzgerald. Excellent play by Fitzgerald, knowing that a player from Danbury was coming out of the sin bin. And now Kuznetsov, fresh off his two-minute minor, comes in, throws a wrist shot, absorbed by Coachman into the corner. And steered aside. Fitzgerald, first man to it, tries to play it up for Ivashkin as Igor Borchersev was coming in with a lot of pace on the play. Now Lopez overskates it partially, but gets it right back up. And now a stretch pass onto the stick of Borchersev, throws a shot. Joseph makes a save, rebound sent wide of the target. Fitzgerald whacks it one, gets it out of the blue line. Danbury is going to have to touch up, finds the stick of Ivashkin, but a good back check by McDonald to end the threat temporarily. Yates now taken down, penalty coming up once again, and the Black Bears are headed right back to the Henny hard seltzer power play.
Yeah, stick into the legs of Gavin Yates, and that's what can happen with a guy who's as fast as Gavin Yates. Ironically, Brooks, Kuznetsov back to the box.
And go ahead and talk about tonight's officials. They've had a busy night with all the penalties they've been giving out by Atlas James Construction Company. Referees Joe Testa and Bill Bird, Isaac Kessler and Dave Hines on the lines.
Looks like it's going to be Newberg, Yates, Lewis, Fitzgerald, and Kirkby on this power play unit for the Black Bears.
Gavin Yates gets to a loose puck, tries to put on a tight turn, held in by Kirkby, and puts it down into the corner. Newberg back over to Yates. Yates and Newberg play one-touch passing with it. Now Mac Lewis picks his head up. Kirkby was streaking, but it's a good thing that the Black Bears didn't pass it back up to the blue line. Nobody was there. Fitzgerald back over to Kirkby. In Dirch's office, throws a shot. Diving effort from Abduella coming out head first into that one.
A dangerous one for Abdella there. Really tough going head first into a shot like that, but laying his body on the line. Upends Kirkby at the end of this one, getting into his legs.
Oh, he went feet first. He just ended head first. He got spun around on the ice.
And what, you know, that's one of those times where you almost, a lot of the times there's going to be more dangerous offensive chances as the Danbury Hattricks win the draw because you get a weird deflection off the defender.
Amesbury coming in on the penalty kill, applying pressure, but Joseph would just steer it on his backhand. And now Kyle Powell crossing his own blue line, puts it over to Boylar. Boylar, low angle, tried to center up. Good back check by Thompson to keep the possession alive. Powell down low, back over to Ivashkin. Powell loads it up for Boylar. One-timer, he scores! Mathieu Boylar, a power play goal! Henny Hard Seltzer getting their money's worth on the sponsorship tonight, and the Black Bears have the lead.
The Quebec native buried that one, Brooks. An excellent job by Kyle Powell, faking the shot, which got Amesbury to full commit down low to block that. Gets it on Boylar's stick, who sneaks it over the blocker of Wilson for the second goal of the game for the Black Bears and leads to a 2-1 lead.
Mathieu Boylar letting them know all the way from Ascot Corner, Quebec. One of two French Canadians on the team, Jeremy Forget, the backup goaltender tonight, also hailing from Quebec. And now the Black Bears up by one. That is Boylar.
We got a little conference here, Brooks.
Yeah, that's Boylar's fifth goal of the season. Powell picks up his 17th assist, keeping pace with Colin Fitzgerald. That's some good D-to-D passing right there.
A little chirping between the benches, Brooks.
Well, what can you expect between these two sides? Ivashkin gets a secondary helper. Kyle Powell, the primary. And Mathieu Boylar, the goal. I wish we had a microphone down there at the bench to really just pick up what was being talked about. Black Bears, Henny, hard seltzer, power play, Alex, now 2 for 5.
Well, it looks like, Brooks, a stick was handed over, so perhaps a stick was lost. Black Bears think it's one of theirs. Grab it and throw it onto their bench. And it looks like the equipment manager from Danbury communicating with the officials.
Equipment managers are the unsung heroes of all hockey leagues. Let's go ahead and give both equipment managers a shout out about that. The work that they put in when the team leaves might not be seen, but it definitely doesn't go unnoticed. 17:38 left to go. Let's hear Frank Perney. Matt Tuboy-Lahr gets his 5th of the season. Kyle Powell, 7th. 13th assist, and Nikita Ivashkin gets his 30th assist of the year as well.
Chad Lopez loses an edge there, Brooks, chasing into the offensive zone on a really good offensive chance.
Fitzgerald, though, recovers in his own end. Black Bears, though, having a hard time getting it out, but Thompson would just nudge it. Doesn't get it deep, but just back out into neutral ice. Gonzalez wraps it all the way around the boards. That's something that we've used to see Danbury do. But Marchessault keeps it in. It goes off the hand of Thompson. Ratcliffe stopping and starting inside the right faceoff dot. Teams jockey for it around the boards. Finds the stick of Ogic, loading it up for Dowler. Kick save. Joseph, puck stays in play. I thought that one got out, but referees say to play on. Coachman steers it over. Black Bears looking for someone to pass to. They were in the midst of a line change. And right, speaking of line change, Newberg blows a tire as soon as he gets out on the ice.
And Brooks, this is the dangerous portion for the Black Bears. You can start to see the legs slow down a little bit, and that's been an issue all season for them. They get a little bit tired at the beginning of the third period, and you can really see them stop moving those feet.
Ogic and Ratcliffe come across the line, and Ogic will throw it into the chest of Joseph as the wave passes by with 16:11 left to go. 26 shots on goal for Danbury, 32 now for the Black Bears.
Yeah, and Brooks, as we talk about that, the Booster Club announced their winning number for the raffles for their stick. It was a Riley McVay stick signed by the entire team. What a prize for a lucky fan to go home with.
Oh, yeah, and you know, you can take part in all these raffles every time the Black Bears have a game. Just head over to the Binghamton Hockey Booster Club. Look out, though, turnover and a shot and a save, and puck is still available. It was right outside. Black Bears take a penalty. And it's cross-checking is going to be the call. I think Brett Parker is going to get the gate. 33 dressed in white. That's the first time I've seen 33 out all night, Alex.
Brooks, earlier, a shift ago, I saw him just take a couple. I believe he was one of the ones just at the end of that shift for the hat tricks as Brett Parker heads to the penalty box.
4 minutes of game time into the third period, and Brett Parker takes another penalty.
And Brett Parker very, very angry with the officials on that one, or very disagreeable, I'd say, on that one, which I guess if you ask most hockey players when they commit a penalty, they're not going to agree with it.
Yep. Kyle Gonzalez, top of the umbrella, loading up for Kuznetsov, one-timer wide of the target. Black Bears get to a loose puck, and now Walters will slap it down the length of the ice, puts it on goal. Kirkby directing out instructions for his Black Bears club. He's out there with Mac Lewis, along with Fitzgerald and Coachman. McKittrick crossing over the line, coming in, weak shot off the backboards. This time, Coachman gets to a loose puck. It hops a stick on McDonald, and those inboards getting very lively here in the third period, just like the fans.
Yeah, Brooks, and you can feel the energy as the wave goes around the arena. The energy's picking up and picking up. Binghamton up and doing a great job on this penalty kill, forcing Danbury to gain every inch ice.
Almost halfway through the Northeastern Striping Corporation penalty kill. Puck knocked back out, and look out. Here goes Austin Thompson on a breakaway, shorthanded. On the forehand, in alone. Save made by Wilson. What a dandy by Brian Wilson to keep this game a one-score affair here. That would have lit this place off.
And what an excellent job by Austin Thompson playing some four-on-one keep away at the end of that one.
Kuznetsov goes down the other end. A two-on-one to Lex to shoot it instead. And Joseph squeezes between his body and his arm on his blocker side to make the save. Take a timeout, come back with more. 14:37 left to go. Black Bears on top, thanks to Matt Tuboy-Lahr on Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton.
And Lahr out there, I got a question for you. Do you know what time? T-shirt toss was brought to you by American Standard Heating and Air Conditioning. Don't settle for less. Ask for American Standard Heating and Air Conditioning, built to a higher standard. Did you miss your puck during tonight's Chuck-a-Puck? If so, scan the QR code on the screen for a second chance to be entered to win the CF Moto ATV from XL Motorsports.
Welcome back to the action. Brooks Hill and Alex Jones on the call tonight. 14:37 left to go, 37 seconds left to go in the Brett Parker minor penalty, Alex.
And on that Austin Thompson breakaway, you'd like to see him. He has to learn from his line mate Nikita Ivashin, wait on the patience, because if he had just waited a half second more, that's a goal in the back of the net.
A little bit of a false start. On the face-off, the linesman communicating over to the penalty box that they're going to hold the clock for 1 second. Chad Lopez wins the face-off, and spinning around with the puck is Matuboy Lahr, and that'll be deflected into the Danbury bench.
Yeah, some fans down there in section 16 got a little bit of a scare as that puck skips right in on the short glass on the side of the bench.
Okay, we also have a note from our great producer, Josh Williams. Number 33 is actually number 10 for Danbury. That's Michael Falengo, for everybody keeping track at home. Due to blood on his jersey, he changed jerseys to an available number during the intermission. So 33 is Falengo. Out in front, Ratcliffe shot denied. Long body effort from JT Walters. Black Bears get to the loose puck, clean it up, and put it down the length of the ice. So one more time, Michael Falenga now wearing 33 in white instead of number 10.
And the penalty power play for the Hatricks is over, Brooks.
Northeastern Striping Corporation penalty kill does it again for the Black Bears, and Brett Parker looking for more, coming out and laying a hit on Ratcliffe as soon as he comes out of the penalty box. D'Angelo pushes off a hit from Jared Yao. Tries to stay on the forecheck, but good stick handling by Ojic. This puck is going to be dumped in, stays in, off the top of the glass. Newberg throws a little bit of a head fake. And interference is going to be the call. And the Black Bears headed right back to the Northeastern Striping Corporation penalty kill.
Yeah, it looks
like they're going to get Newberg for bluffing that he was going to hit the guy. If we get this look at the replay. Or wait, hold on. No one's gone over. And Newberg still. Could have been too many. I did not see the indication. I got ahead of myself right there.
Call for interference. It looks like it's on Brett Parker.
Parker headed right back to the penalty box.
Brett Parker out there, Brooks?
Yeah, he was still out there.
I know they were in the midst of a line change there. Oh, yep. Give us a little shoulder there. That's going to be an interference call. It's just Ojic off the skates. And just an unfortunate penalty from Brett Parker. Not one you want to take after killing a huge penalty, after successfully killing off a huge power play.
Parker gets two more for interference. Not going to get much contest from the Black Bears on that one. That's a letter of a law interference. Danbury's power play is 0-for-3. They're trying to tie the game up, making it 1-for-4 on the night. Binghamton does get to a loose puck. Fitzgerald throws it off the glass, not too hard. Takes a funny bounce off the inboard and forcing Danbury to chase after it in their own end. 30 seconds gone in the penalty. Thompson and Lewis, first forwards out. Boylar run into at the line by McDonald, but Walters does exit the zone with a slap shot going right off for a change. Now McKittrick crossing over at the line. He's back-checked. Marchessin wraps it around the boards. Fitzgerald met in a one-on-one battle. Tries to poke it ahead for Thompson. He does. And the native of Leamington, Ontario will glide it down. Wilson coming back out to set it up.
And the Black Bears are able to get the full line change with Thompson coming off after clearing that puck.
Halfway through the Northeastern Striping Corporation penalty kill. And now Jared Yao. Sidesteps not one, but two Black Bears. Yao tries going for the centering tipped out in front. Didn't connect with anything. Ojic at the line, runs into Ivashkin. Ivashkin whacked at, got his skates taken out from underneath him. And we have a whistle from the referee at the end of the play. D- Didn't see the arm go up in the air. I believe they just called that one pinned up against the boards.
Yeah, and I think Brooks, too, that might have been even just a safety call. With Ivashkin down on the ice like that, it's going to be a difficult one with that many sticks coming in. That one, Brooks.
Yeah,
he got in
and
escaped.
He's on top of it.
And you know what, Brooks? It's also one of those you say, you know what, we'll give you the offensive zone draw. We'll give you the advantage of that, but we'll also take the player out of a dangerous situation where sticks and skates are coming in.
Borshev and Newberg facing off with each other. In the faceoff dot, tied up. To Bennett, wins it back to Ratcliffe. Ratcliffe over to Ogic, coming in. Loading it up for Yao, shot wide of the target. Off the inboards, Coachman tries to get to it, hops over his stick, Borshev behind the net. Now back over to DeBennett. Ratcliffe loads it back over, a little bit behind. Yao shot high and wide. Off the glass, stays in play. 10 seconds left to go in the Parker penalty. Ratcliffe draws a man with him, circles back around. Parker's up and ready. Yao loads the cannon, throws a shot into the chest of Taylor Joseph. And Brett Parker has returned once again.
Yeah, Brooks, an excellent penalty kill by the Black Bears there, not allowing the Danbury Hat Tricks any prime real estate opportunities for shots on net, forcing their forwards and defenders to stay outside of those danger areas that you mark on the ice. An excellent job by the Black Bears killing that one off. Got to say, a lot of momentum in the bag here, and you can feel it. The fans are getting up, getting excited to some Cotton Eye Joe.
Always a timeless classic. Black Bears win the faceoff. Mac Lewis in the corner will now use his own net for a little bit of separation. Stopping and starting. Good display of skating. He does get the puck out of the zone, but unfortunately turns it right back over to the Hat Tricks. Falanga shoots it in. Joseph will glide it over to Kyle Powell. He's met with a double team. Powell bluffed the double team and now has plenty of time and room to start the breakout. Amesbury forechecking. And now Gavin Yates. Yates, one-man show, a lot of speed for Yates. Low angle shot. It's off the side of the net. I didn't know where the puck was. Was looking for the red light and the official cutting, pinching in. Throws it towards the net. Kirkby tries to center up. Ivashkin has it on his backhand, back up to cutting. Slap shot, tipped on by Kirkby, and Wilson made the save. Yates down low, back up to the point for Powell. Another one-timer, this time tipped off of Falanga. Kirkby taken down in front, no call. We play on, cutting, holding it in at the red line. Delayed offsides, Black Bears skate off. Cutting and Amesbury with a little bit of extracurriculars with each other, but cutting does not drop the gloves there. Thrown in, and Wilson has no time left but to hang on.
Well, Brooks, here's the thing. That is an excellent, excellent gamesmanship play by cutting there. Amesbury's trying to bait him into a fight, and the puck had to be held in the Danbury zone while that was going on. Cutting lets him do all the jawing, lets him do all the slapping, and then just turns and skates away after eating up about 30 seconds of game time. If you're down a goal, you don't have the luxury to be doing that if you're Danbury.
10:09 left to go here. Chad Lopez pushes the faceoff back, but read perfectly by Marchessault. Here crossover with McKittrick. McKittrick taken down by Coachman right in front of the referee legally, but gets back up on his feet, puts it over to Gonzalez. Open ice off the skate of Thompson on the wrist shot, but hops over near the crease, and Taylor Joseph melts it down with 9:51 left to go here. Going down the stretch in Binghamton. We're going to step aside, come back with more. Black Bears have a 2-1 lead on Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton.
Adina Setzer, Dwayne Setzer, all happy birthday. Madison. Madison Becker, Megan Sanford, George Sweezy, and a big happy 40th anniversary to Raymond and Doreen Ralston.
Off one back by Dan Barry. Abuelo gets a little bit of separation. There's a shot that just receives all the way and tracked down by the goaltender.
An excellent job by
Ben. Head on over to the section 24 and 25 corner if you are sticking around after tonight's game for one of the post-game skating with the players.
Face off going right back to Abuelo. Abuelo fumbled with it in a stick, but Gonzalez picked it back up. Blackbears can go the other way if they hurry with numbers. Chad Lopez starts his engine, crosses over the line. Even man rush, 3-on-3, tries to center up, nobody home. Fitzgerald pinching in, gets a stick to it, and gets it deep enough behind the Danbury net. Centering sent out in front, cleaned up by DeBennett. And now McKittrick coming down the right wing side. McKittrick skating through the ice, throws a shot through the five.
Pull and save made by Joseph. Left though for DeBennett, high and wide on the wrist shot follow-up attempt. Fitzgerald gets to a loose puck.
An excellent job there by the Black Bears cutting off that attack, a 3-on-2 that turned into a dangerous opportunity to have an offensive zone chance of their own.
Walters pestered on the way through by Borshishev. Borshishev emptying the tank here on his forechecking shift. Newberg tries to play it over cross ice to Parker. Yao fumbled with it, and the team's volleying back and forth like a tennis match right now. Tape to take pass finds Ratcliffe, left wing. Throws on the brakes, waits for his defenseman to join the play. He'll wrap it all the way around the boards, but Taylor Joseph coming out to play the puck. Chipped away by Parker, held in though by Danbury. Off the inboards, Kuznetsov first man to it. D'Angelo tries to throw a stick at it, pops up high into the air and into row 2 in section 4.
Hey Brooks, I think this one's gonna be interesting to see if this one leaves the zone or stays there. Who's it going off? Who did they determine that played the puck originally? Looks like we're staying in the offensive zone.
Ojic wins the faceoff, back to McDonald. This shot off the inboards. Boy, Lars taken out in front. Might have lost his edge on the way through. Powell chasing after it with Falenga. Powell will be the first man to it. Tries to play it out of the zone, and the Black Bears escape harm. Here comes Gavin Yates on sides, left wing side. Shot steered away by Wilson, deflected into the net. Kirkby tripped over the goaltender's stick, and now he's going to be met with a hodgepodge of hat tricks right out in front. I don't think anything's coming of this one.
No, Brooks, this late in the game, you don't want to lose anybody. This is a deeper line, the second line for the hat tricks. A lot of important players here. Don't want to lose anybody over an accidental bump into the keeper's skate.
See if we get a high energy replay on this one. So here comes a shot from Gavin Yates. Kirkby's crashing the net, oh. And he just skates the stick of Wilson and the leg of Kirkby get tied up.
And as always in hockey, everybody's going to jumble up together and talk a little bit.
Faceoff one back by the hat tricks as McDonald gets to the loose puck, playing it up above the head of Tyson Kirkby. Ojic tries to seal Kirkby against the boards. He's successful. Low angle shot, and Joseph almost had another one bank in off a body part, but does a good job of steering it out in front of the net. 7:40 left to go here. Going down the stretch, Kirkby gets the red line. Stays with the puck, the lefty, low angle shot. Might have just been flicking it over to Gavin Yates on the near side. McDonald and Ivashkin tie up with each other, but it'll be the hat tricks playing it out into the Black Bears zone. Colin Fitzgerald letting some precious seconds tick off the clock. Justin Coachman almost acting as a screen out in front, like he was boxed across. Waiting for everybody to get to their spots. Ivashkin starts making a stride, and now Marchessault will start to come. And now Fitzgerald almost toying with Marchessault. If this works out for the Black Bears, it's a great play by Fitzgerald. He will dump it, but going to be knocked away by Abduella, so nothing will come of it. Stretch pass onto the stick of DeBennett, touching Marchessault. Two on one for Danbury. Out in front, Joseph might have got a foot to it. Abduella over to Gonzalez. Wrist shot swallowed up by a defender. That's Fitzgerald out in front. Danbury's offsides. They have to wait. They touch up. And Marchessault too early into the zone with 6:27 left to go.
Brooks, I got to give him his roses here. What an excellent shift by Colin Fitzgerald, just absolutely bodying everybody across the ice. First off, playing a little bit of keep away with Marchessault, getting his body in front of a puck and blocking a good scoring opportunity for the hat tricks and making sure it gets outside the zone.
Neutral zone faceoff in front of the Black Bears bench. 6:27 left to go here in this one. Parker tries to push it forward. Instead, Danbury pushes it deep. Joseph will play it over to Walters. D-to-D passing over to Boylar. Boylar with the difference maker so far in this one. Two power play goals tonight for the Black Bears. One even strength goal for the hat tricks. Borchersev crosses over the red line, now the blue line. Tries to go around Boylar. He does temporarily, but loses control of the puck in the process. Power move, Boylar sends him into the back of the net. Danbury keeps it in. Dowler looking for a slap pass. Off the inboards, Borchersev backhand centering attempt is denied. Newberg and Amesbury join the party. Newberg picking off a little bit of Amesbury.
Amesbury is so difficult in these situations with that huge stick of his.
Yeah, and also just a big frame. It's a tough guy to move. Look out, though. Black Bears turn it over. Centering pass denied by Walters. Walters has done an excellent job blocking passes and shots tonight. Now Falenga putting on a tight turn as Borchersev, very tired at the end of his shift, getting off. Dowler throwing a shot, looking for a tip from Amesbury out in front. It's off the glass instead. Walters will backhand it around. Brett Parker takes a peek. He has a man coming from behind. And now Dowler up to the umbrella. Yao skating around. Black Bears are very tired. They need a whistle or a line change. Boylar takes a pass, and Amesbury's going to go.
Yeah, that's going to probably be one from Amesbury.
Taylor Joseph coming in to lend a hand. JT Walters has lost his helmet in the process. Best thing for the Black Bears right now, Alex, as hard as it is, skate away.
No, Brooks going to be 4-on-4. They're calling one on Joseph. It's going to leave the Black Bears incredulous that they got that, because the penalty on Amesbury was so, so outrageous that you got to let it sit. But Taylor Joseph says he's got to stick up for his guy.
So now the Black Bears are going to have to put somebody in the penalty box, because obviously Joseph can't serve the penalty himself. 14:58, the time of the penalties.
And that's another cross check to the back of the head, Brooks, which is become a staple of that particular player. Right up under the helmet of JT Walters. It looked like it caught him from the wider replay. Nope, right in the numbers, Brooks. But still a cross check nonetheless. You gotta, if you're Taylor Joseph there, you gotta not take that. That's just not the smart play to make. You got Taylor cutting in the box on the opposite side. Guys doing a little chatting.
Going to be 4-on-4.
A lot more space on the ice for both teams.
Yep.
Gavin Yates, Tyson Kirkby, Colin Fitzgerald, and Justin Coachman. 5:02 left in a 4-on-4 for 2 minutes.
Puck becomes available, and Gavin Yates thought about just shooting it down the ice, but realized it's 4-on-4. Now Yates runs through Jared Yao. And Amesbury gets two for roughing officially. And Taylor Joseph gets 2 minutes for roughing as well. Icing against Danbury because we're even on the ice. So this will come back in the other way with 4:35 left to go here in the period. Taking our final timeout of the night. Back with you after these messages. 2-1 coming up after this on Fox Sports 1430. welcome back into Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton. Worldwide Sports Supply ice crew shoveling off of the first layer of snow. Still out there on the ice. And it's 4-on-4, Alex, for the Nets, 93 seconds. Tully Cutting sitting in the box for the Taylor Joseph roughing call, and Daniel Ansberry, two for roughing as well.
Yeah, Brooks, 2 minutes roughing on a rare one for a goalkeeper. And the Black Bears win the draw, ends up on Colin Fitzgerald. Sick. Coach Moon with a long shot into the glove of Brian Wilson.
4:29 left to go here. Yates and DeBennett facing off, but Yates is a little bit early. He's going to be ushered out. Fitzgerald, a wrist shot, blocked by Yao. And Yates chasing after a good display of stick handling, left a man in the dust behind the net. Now Gavin Yates going around the net. Tyson Kirkby running out of real estate. He takes a push from Kyle Gonzalez. Kirkby stopping and starting behind the Danbury net. Black Bears doing a good job of watching some time tick off the clock while the puck is in the offensive zone. Yates circling around. Leaves it for Fitzgerald. Fitzgerald now, his turn. Through the slot. Passes over to Kirkby, hops his stick. And now Danbury gets control of the puck. 3-on-2 for the Black Bears. For the hat tricks. Left it back. Errant pass. And DeBennett lost control. Gavin Yates going the other way. And Yates left it, maybe hitting some dry spots out on the ice conditions here late in the contest. Kuznetsov lost it. Boydlar tries to play it out, not going to be able to. McDonald on the forecheck. And now Lopez pins it up against the board, takes a look, tries to find Ivoshkin on the stretch pass. Nothing's there. Lopez and Ogic fighting after it. Right in front of the Black Bears bench. Penalties coming up. And they're going to give Lopez the gate now for tripping at 3:05.
Not popular with the fans here, Brooks.
Four seconds. Taylor Cutting comes out of the box with Daniel Amesbury. Black Bears will have to kill off another Northeastern Striping Corporation penalty kill, Alex, if they want to win this one.
Yeah, Brooks, it's a huge penalty kill for the Black Bears. If they kill it off, it'll end at 1:05 left in the third period. Huge to see if they can keep their legs underneath them. Let's see the replay, the Heinz Energy replay, Brooks. Yep, that'll do it.
Yep. Anytime your stick gets in between the skates of a player.
And we get the sign to let the clock stop or let the clock run or hold for 1 second before, after this draw.
Marshall Sands been kicked out of the faceoff dot, and McKittrick will be asked to come in and take his spot. Pushed up to the blue line. Gonzalez coming in. Cutting has returned. Shot and a save made by Joseph. 5-on-4. Traditional power play now for the hat tricks. Three defensemen and Josh Newberg, the lone forward. Black Bears trying to push the puck out of the zone. They are unsuccessful. Three defensemen out there on the ice. Shot blocked by Coachman out in front. Now for McDonald. In the right wing dot. Back to Gonzalez. Kuznetsov loading it up. Save made by Joseph. Got the pad to it. McKittrick sealed off, and McKittrick can hold it in. Kuznetsov can hold it in. Always dangerous. Now Gonzalez matched by Cutting. Gets a lot of space into the chest of the goaltender. Puck's available. Newberg can't get it out of the zone. Back up to his ice. Shot in a goal. Danbury ties the game up on the power play.
Yeah, just an unfortunate one there, Brooks. It looks like the gas has run out for Newberg on that play. Did not get it in the back of the net. Did not get the puck clear when he had it on his stick. You'd love it. Was a long, long shift for Newberg, but this has been an issue all season for the Black Bears, not able to clear the puck after long periods of time, specifically during the penalty kill. If they can get that puck, if they can get that on the stick, Taylor Joseph gets up and just gets tipped into the back of the net.
17:44 time of the goal, and now Danbury has tied the game up at 2. Pamela on. Now back over. And now Borchersev crossing the line off the mask of the goaltender. And now Binghamton will try to start their engine going the other way. Mac Lewis. Nobody's with him, so he just has to dump it in. John McDonald getting the power play goal. McDonald's fifth goal of the year. And now Ratcliffe goes one on two. Walters first to the loose puck. Black Bears trying to generate some offense here late in the contest. 90 seconds left in regulation time. Gonzalez wraps it around the boards. This will be icing against Danbury with 1:22 left to go.
Well, let's the Black Bears get a set play going into this faceoff in the offensive zone. Lopez, Thompson, Ivashkin going to be out there for the Black Bears. Fitzgerald and Coachman, let's see if they can make a little magic here, Brooks.
Yeah, Black Bears only have 6 shots on goal so far for this period, Alex. Assists on the goal go to Michael Marchesan and Dmitry Kuznetsov. Puck available in the blue paint. Where is it? Referee blows the whistle. And now players piling on top of each other here late in the period.
Looks like it's going to stay 5-on-5, Brooks, as much as Yao protests. Staying to the right of Brian Wilson, his blocker side.
Left side.
Left side, sorry, Brooks.
Glove side, you're
Black
good.
Bears, Black Bears right side, Wilson's left side. And that's his trapper side. I'm all discombobulated.
1:15 left to go here in the third period. Lopez wins the faceoff back to Fitzgerald, looking for a tip save made by Wilson. Thompson hammered down to the ice out in front of the goaltender. Now McKittrick trying to cross the line with Marchesan. Marchesan will wrap it around the boards. McKittrick seals it up against the boards. Final minute of regulation time here. Dump in onto the stick. Ivashkin separated from the puck. Marchesan takes a bump from Thompson. Black Bears try to get to the loose puck. Ivashkin trying to turn around. Boylar. Aaron play. Ivashkin was taken down.
Hey, where's
out
the,
in front.
Absolutely, Brooks. An insane no call there from the officials. Ivashkin got two-handed by Gonzalez in the ribcage and just a no call right in front of the official.
Danbury is going to luck out with that trade, Alex. Just took off a guy who has over 30 goals for the Black Bears against one of your defensemen for Danbury. It'll be a 4-on-4 for the final 35 seconds of regulation time.
He gets ragdolled, but if there's a camera angle on it later in the play, Gonzalez, as Nikita Ivashkin's getting up off the ice, he gets a two-hander to the ribcage from Gonzalez.
Center ice faceoff. Black Bears try to chase after it. Ogic will go one-on-one, throw a shot into the glove of Taylor Joseph, who will melt it down. Looks like both of them are going to get 2 minutes for roughing. That's the second time this period that we've seen matching roughing calls at the same time.
I mean, that is an absurd call, Brooks. Absolutely absurd. Just an atrocious call. They're calling an interference.
Black Bears win the faceoff, but they have a hard time getting it out. Now McDonald tied the game up at 2 on the power play with the puck. Poked away by Colin Fitzgerald, and here skate after Kuznetsov with it. 15 seconds left to go. Looks like Danbury might get the final chance. Kuznetsov throws a shot into the glove of Joseph, and he will melt it down.
And Brooks, this has long-term ramifications as well for both teams. Gonzalez, an alternate captain, a guy who also plays a bit on their three-on-three squads. Nikita Ivashkin, a big part of the Black Bears offense, will probably go into the extra time period four-on-four with the offsetting penalties.
Yates tries to win it back. Abdullah keeps it in, looks for a shot, deflected out in front. And Danbury has scored with 4 seconds left to go. Black Bears pleading to the officials on a high stick call.
Yeah, it was we're already gonna have to look at the replay, Brooks. It looked like, to my eye, that was a high stick, but we'll see.
They're gonna bring the linesman in. Some people.
And it looks like Nikita's been bounced from the game.
Just a unfortunate bounce out in front.
That's over, Brooks. That's at head level there. Up and that's why they pay the officials the big bucks, Brooks. That is a brutal call to make. It depends on who you ask is how high that stick was.
Black Bears final push. They're not going to get anything out of it. And out of nowhere, Danbury comes from behind with 2 minutes left. Scores on the power play to tie the game up. And they score with 4 seconds left to take the lead. Black Bears are going to be left wondering what happened in the final 2 minutes. We're going to try to figure it out, step aside, come back with more on Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton.
Fans, please do not throw anything on the ice. Please do not throw anything on the ice. You will be removed and possibly prosecuted. Tonight's rock rotates our starting Budweiser, three stars.